This is the Countdown to Kickoff, presented by State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Good Saturday afternoon and welcome to Alan E. Paulson Stadium on the campus of Georgia Southern University in Statesboro. Side of today's Southern Conference matchup between the number one ranked Appalachian State Mountaineers and your Georgia Southern Eagles. Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair alongside my broadcast partners, Terry Harvin, Ryan Chambers, Russ Brown, and studio producer Rick Pittman Jr. on hand to bring you today's play-by-play story. It's homecoming 2010 at Georgia Southern, and the battle for first-year head coach Jeff Munkin is anything but a cupcake. For the first time in four seasons, the Mountaineers come off the rock and face the Eagles without Armani Edwards, the two-time Peyton Award winner, currently trying his hand in the National Football League. However, Coach Terry Moore in his 22nd season up in Boone brings in an even more impressive high-powered offense, at least statistically, than the Eagles faced a year ago in the dreadful 52-16 beatdown in Boone. Junior signal caller DeAndre Presley and his core of receivers lead the Southern Conference in scoring and total offense, along with a defense that boasts three of the 20 FCS players on the current Buchanan watch list. One of the few statistical categories that Georgia Southern leads in the Southern Conference may serve them well today. That's in time of possession. Keeping the Mountaineers' offense sitting on the sideline has to be a mission today for the Eagles' offense, which has really struggled to find consistency at times this season, including last week in the loss to Samford. It's the 26th meeting between the Mountaineers and Eagles on the gridiron that dates back to 1932. The Mountaineers lead the overall series 13-11 and one tie. Appalachian State has won four out of the last five and try for the first time today to win three in a row over Georgia Southern since 1995, 1996, and 1997. Coach Moore and company also can be just the second team in history to beat the Eagles in modern football history three times in a row at Paulson behind the Wofford Terriers, who reached that feat just a few weeks ago. Should the Eagles find a way to upset yet another number one ranked team inside Paulson Stadium, it will also snap the Southern Conference second longest conference winning streak at 26 games by Appalachian State. That streak began following their 2007 loss at home in Boone to these Eagles of Georgia Southern. The stadium expected to be covered in blue come kickoff as Georgia Southern tries to make the black and gold black and blue. It's number one Appalachian State, Georgia Southern, homecoming at the prettiest little stadium in America.
Hi, fans. This is Chris Blair, voice of the Georgia Southern Eagles, for my friends at the Sir Shop in Statesboro. The Sir Shop outfits me year-round in all the name brands like the North Face, Southern Tide, Guy Harvey, Costa Del Mar, Seven Jeans, and Southern Proper. Embroidered game day clothes and a full line of seasonal wear. The Sir Shop has everything this dad could ever need. So whether I'm following the Eagles on the road or calling the blue and white, putting an Eagle 600 at Paulson, I stay comfortable. Quality, fashion, variety. That's the Sir Shop, Statesboro's finest men's fashions. Call 764-6924.
This is Jamie Cartee with St. Andrews Builders. For nearly 20 years, our company has provided construction services to this area. Although we specialize in quality-built custom homes, our team can also help you to remodel or add to your existing home. St. Andrews Builders is also licensed for light commercial and office construction. We are very proud to be one of the 100 members of the Southern Living Custom Builder Program. This affiliation allows us to provide many benefits to our customers. So stop by our office on Mulberry Street or visit us online at standrewsbuilders.com.
Quickly underway here as Georgia Southern won the toss, deferred to the second half. They kick off to the Mountaineers. Travaris Cadet fields it at the 15 on a short kickoff and moves it to the 49-yard line. And we're underway here. First quarter action, Georgia Southern, Appalachian State. Presley in trouble. Gives it off. Short hopped in the backfield. On the swing pass to Frazier, it's incomplete. Sets up second down and 10. The first half kickoff presented by Geico Insurance. For a free rate quote, visit geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. 15 minutes could save you hundreds on auto insurance. DeAndre Presley, the junior quarterback out of Tampa, Florida, one of the Peyton candidates here for 2010. And he leads in the top 10 in three categories in college football. We'll tell you about it after the second down and 10 from the Appalachian State 49-yard line. Out of the shotgun, puts it in the belly of Travaris Cadet. He's dropped back at the 45. Eagles all over the Appalachian State Mountaineers. And with 14:37 to play, just underway first quarter, Georgia Southern comes out fighting, Terry, defensively.
Excellent play, right to get off the start. We start off with Eubanks on a blitz. He nails the quarterback as he tries to get rid of the ball. Russell's in great positions and just creams the running back for a three-yard loss. This is a great way to start after an extremely sorry kickoff and a good return by App State.
Quickly, third down, 13. Back at the 46-yard line of the Mountaineers. Presley out of a shotgun. One back on a wing to his left. He'll step back three steps in the pocket. Fires this one deep down the field. LaRon Scott in coverage. Looking for Brian Quick. Well overthrown down around the five. And quickly, Appalachian State three and out. They'll have to punt it away to the Eagles with 14:03 to play here in the first quarter. Time now to introduce today's officiating crew presented by Dr. Horace Neal and Professional Eye Care of Statesboro. To make the right call every day, you can't afford to compromise your vision. Schedule your visit with Dr. Horace Neal and the staff at Professional Eye Care of Statesboro, the official team eye doctor of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Referee Ed Rhodes, umpire Stanford Jackson, linesman Robert Broom, line judge Terry Mock, side judge Rob Rantz, field judge is Greg Brock, and the back judge is Jay Neal. Here's Sam Martin. Martin to punt it away from his very own 35. High kick. Eagles trying to get out of the way. Takes an Eagle bounce up around the 29. And it'll be down there. They'll say out of bounds at the 27. Georgia Southern takes over. First down and 10. 13:53 to play in the first quarter. No score. Let's pause 10 seconds for station identification. So great stations like 1490 WSNT in Sandersville and 105.3 WSGC in Elberton can identify themselves on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
For Eagle Nation, Eagle 102.9 WPMX Statesboro, a Georgia Eagle broadcasting station.
57 degrees, game time temperature, blustery winds here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. First down and 10 at the 30-yard line is where they'll start off. Jay Bo Shaw, the junior quarterback, under center. Darion Robinson started to move in motion. He's one of the A-backs. J.J. Wilcox, the other. Robert Brown, the true freshman out of Macon, is your fullback. Handoff Robinson going far side and covered up by Jabari Fletcher. Real quickly, the senior out of Atlanta, Georgia. 40 tackles, 11 and a half for a loss this season. He's got 7 sacks and an interception. He is one of the 3 members of the Mountaineer defense on the Buchanan watch list, and he is a world beater at right defensive end.
No doubt about that one. In fact, on that play, Robinson should have cut up. Brown made his block. Robinson didn't cut up on that play. Loss of a yard on the play. Second 11.
Back at the 28-yard line, Shaw. Now with an I formation. Brown and Robinson. Shaw, option. Now he'll try to cut it back upside. Across the 30, makes his way to the 34-yard line. A pickup of 6. Sets up third down and 6. Dan Wiley, the junior out of Washington, Georgia, on the stop.
Something to watch for. App State over pursuit there on the right side of the defensive line. I think they expected Jabo not to keep, and maybe from seeing the tape and knowing that maybe not at 100%, Jabo kept it instead. And they can't over pursue like that. They'll give up a big one down the road.
Third down and 6. The Eagles on the season. 5th in the Southern Conference in third down conversions at only 41%. Offset I formation again with Brown and Wilcox. Robinson, the A-back, in motion. They'll give the right off. Robert Brown lost the football, dive for it, and Appalachian State picks it up and on the run. Moving the other way is Bobby Bozo, and he'll be dropped back and finally pulled down around the Eagle 10-yard line. And Robert Brown has the fumble problems, and it continues here today with 12:20 to play in the first quarter. Gives it back to the Mountaineers inside the Eagle red zone. First down and 10. They'll mark him down at the 12-yard line of the Eagles.
No doubt. You can get away with that against the Citadel. Might even be able to get away with it against Samford and Western Carolina. Can't get away with that against Appalachian State. Need this defense to bone up again and do a very solid job that they did last time. App State started the ball game on their own 49-yard line. Great field position. Now they did it again because of a costly turnover, and they're getting the ball on the 12-yard line. So we need this 12th man who's in blue to turn it up a notch right now.
Presley out of the shotgun. He'll send one receiver out wide to the left, one to the right side. Cadet on a wing to the right side. First down, 10 at the 12. 12:20 to play, first quarter. No score, Appalachian State, Georgia Southern. Presley, shotgun snap. Puts it in the belly of Cadet. And Brent Russell just shakes him down at the 20-yard line. Brent Russell's back there nearly taking off the handoff. And Russell says, Cadet, going to bring it down. 6-1, 2-10, not much of a matchup. Against 6'2", 287.
He knows how to turn it up a notch in these big games, doesn't he, Ryan? That's why this kid is a Buchanan candidate right now.
Matt Ruff, number 70 on the right side for Appalachian State, just got owned. And this is a matchup with Tinsley coming off his outside shoulder to watch.
Second down, 18, now back at the 20-yard line. Presley looking to the far sideline to Jerry Moore in his 22nd season. 197 wins, 76 losses, 3 national titles. At Appalachian State, Presley, option, he'll keep it. He's got a lot of room, 15, now breaks it outside. near the 5-yard line before stepping out at the 4. So Presley gets it back. The junior out of Tampa, great run, and this time great blocking on the right side of that offensive line. Ori Fry and Matt Ruff cleared it out.
What a great play call by Appalachian State, using Presley's speed to almost run the Georgia Southern offense to the right-hand side. He has a good read, sees it's wide open, uses his speed, and next thing you know, they're knocking on the door at third and one.
Third and one now at the 3-yard line of the Eagles, 11-17 to play. Quick snap, Presley again going right side, now cuts it back against the grain, and he'll dive in for the score. And the Mountaineers take the lead 6-0 with 11-12 to play here in the first quarter. Tackle made by Russell. Right at the end zone, but Presley already breaking the goal line. And in comes Jason Bataris for the point after.
Not bad when you're starting on your 12-yard line.
Coach Munkin talked about it all week, and that is not giving up turnovers. And unfortunately, the Eagles come out in their opening drive and cough it up. Terrace, the point after, shanks this one, but it gets through the left upright on the season, 38 of 42 coming in. He's now 39 of 43, and it's 7-0. Appalachian State with the lead, 11-12 to play in the first quarter. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
Leases for 36 months, 12,000 miles per year with zero down on Camry and Prius, $4,400 down on Tundra. Tundra discount includes all rebates and discounts with approved credit through November 1st, 2010. See dealer for details.
No interest for 60 months. No money down. No payments till January. All at Franklin Toyota Scion in Statesboro. New 2011 Camrys, just $254 a month with no money down. Or no interest for 60 months and no payments till January. Zero for 60 on 2010 Priuses with no payments till January. Or just $256 a month with no money down. Plus, up to $5,500 off 2011 Tundras. Or just $399 a month. And get 2 years free maintenance on all new Toyotas. Franklin Toyota Scion's a proud sponsor of Southern's Homecoming, Saturday, November 6th at 2 o'clock. We'll have a new Tundra on site, and you can register to win a $50 gift certificate to the university store. So come see us. We'll save you money. Beside the new Holiday Inn or at franklintoyota.com. It's Franklin Toyota.
Today's broadcast is an exclusive copyrighted presentation of the Georgia Southern Radio Network through rights granted by Georgia Southern University. Thank you for listening and enjoy today's game.
Georgia Southern True Blue, defined as diehard, enthusiastic, lifetime supporter of Georgia Southern University. Are you True Blue? Join the Alumni Association today. Visit alumni.georgiasouthern.edu or call 912-GSU-ALUM. 7-0, Appalachian State with the lead. After the Eagles coughed it up on the fumble in their opening drive, set the Mountaineers up at the 12-yard line. Here's the kick from Bataris. Fielded by LaRon Scott, bobbled it at about the 11-yard line and makes his way up across the 25 to about the 26-yard line. Georgia Southern takes over offensively, first down and 10 at the 26-yard line with 11:06 to play here in the first quarter, down 7-0 to the number one team in the land.
That kickoff I actually liked because he's kicking into the wind. You'd think he'd hang it up. Instead, it was more of a low-line drive kick. A great return effort by LaRon Scott, just not able to do anything with it. I was really hoping something big on that play right there as the Eagles start on their own 26-yard line.
Brandavius Mann will put his nose over the football here. Snap it to Jabo Shaw. Robert Brown is your fullback. Give it off to Brown, who fumbled last time out. Makes his way across the 30 up to about the 31-yard line. Very good pickup on the dive. Just right behind Brandavius Mann, Maxwell, and Blake DeBartolo. That offensive line sets up second down and 5 for the Eagles here with 10:48, clock moving, first quarter, 7-0. Appalachian State with the lead.
It's worth noting, everyone in health, though, Toby Akinronye not in uniform, Ian Street closing the sidelines.
Ooh.
Second down and 5 at the 31-yard line of their very own. Jabo Shaw under center takes a snap. He'll roll out, option near side. Flag comes out, and Jabo dropped at about the 33. Flag coming out in the Eagle backfield. Brandon Greer made the stop, but it looks like this one will go against Georgia Southern.
That'll go against Robert Brown. He moved too early, illegal shift. He moved too early at the fullback position. Saw that one from here, was surprised. And Coach Munkin not happy with it either, as he's out to the numbers on the field, voicing his displeasure.
2 minute motion, hop in. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Puts us back at second down and 10. Decent crowd coming in a little bit late today. Most of them wearing blue, as today is Blue Out, fifth annual Blue Out. Eagle Nation across the world listening on the internet as well. Appreciate them.
After the penalty, second down, 10, back at the Eagle 26-yard line. Working from the left hash, attacking left to right. Shaw, sprint out, near side, fires, catch going to be made. Williford's got it, but hogtied immediately at the 33-yard line. But picking up some of those yards back to make it at least manageable here on third down and about three. They mark it at the 33-yard line.
Certainly does give us an opportunity to convert here.
As I mentioned, Georgia Southern fumbled it on their last third down attempt. 41% on the season coming into the game, something they had to improve on today against the number one team in FCS football. Here's the quick toss. Nico Hickey in the backfield. Too much time, and he's dropped immediately at the 35-yard line. Jabari Fletcher and DJ Smith combining on the tackle. They'll be short of the first down. It should be fourth and a little bit. Looks like 2 yards, maybe just a yard here, a little less than two, but Charlie Edwards will have to come out and punt it away, and Charlie could be a weapon today. The sophomore out of Tifton, Georgia, has 7 punts this season over 50 yards, averaging 42 yards, and has a long of 57. He'll need a boot here. He's got the wind to his back as he stands at the 20-yard line, and Travis Cadet stands down at the 24. High snap, but Charlie gets it away. It's high into the air, and Cadet will call for the fair catch. Far side, fielded at the 20-yard line. That's where the Mountaineers take over. 8:47 to play, first quarter, and Appalachian State leading 7-0.
Great punt. Good 45 yards on that punt, I believe. That's right. 45-yard punt for Charlie Edwards. He hung it up high. Cadet, who's got an amazing speed, certainly a threat back there. Couldn't return the ball. Well, on that third down conversion play, Shaw led him nicely on the pitch, and Nico just wasn't able to turn the corner. And you can't stutter step with Jabari Fletcher. I mean, he's a good senior defensive end. He's going to drag you down, and that's exactly what he did.
Presley out of a shotgun. Too wide to the left. Too wide to the short side of the field. That's the right side. Presley firing across the middle. Catch is made at the 35. It's B.J. Frazier dropped at the 41-yard line. But a great pickup of 21 yards quickly, and it's first down and 10 for the Mountaineers. They made that one look real easy across the middle.
Certainly did. Cadet not missing a beat, or Presley not missing a beat as well back there at quarterback. Showing a little Armani arm strength on him as he zips that one across right over the seam there.
Quick moving offense with 8:30 to play first quarter. They're lined up two wide to the right, two to the left. Presley again out of the shotgun. One back on a wing to his right side. Presley again looking to throw. Pocket collapsing. Presley is brought down and stays on his feet and makes his way back just shy of the line of scrimmage. Georgia Southern had him deep at about 6 yards behind the line, but Josh Rowe eventually brings him down right at the 40. No loss, no gain on the play. It'll set up second down. They'll say maybe 10 and a half.
Great. I mean, look at the strength of Presley. I mean, able to get back to the line of scrimmage. You hit it on the nose. That was a 6-yard loss.
Second down, they'll say 11. Just shy of the 40-yard line. Two backs now, one to each side. Devin Moore and Cadet. Presley shotgun snap. Gives it off. It'll be Devin Moore. Not much doing across the 40 to the 41-yard line. That's all. It'll be third down and about 9 upcoming with 7:33 to play here in the first quarter. Appalachian State leading 7-0 after the costly miscue and the fumble by the Eagles inside the red zone.
DeBose doing a good job folding down from that defensive end position. He's playing on the right side. Coming down on the running back, not biting on the fake. The quarterback going to keep it, I mean. Stays with the running back.
Chris. Appalachian State third and third down offense conversions on the season. 44% on the year. Presley, shotgun snap, fires, and this one's caught. Carson Hill didn't even make a play, and the catch is made at the Eagle 45-yard line to Brian Quick.
Brian Quick, what an amazing wide receiver he is. We remember when he was a freshman. Just unbelievable. Kid 6'5", 220. And I remember he made that amazing catch in the end zone last time he was here. Just a good route. We didn't do a good job covering it, Chris.
Well, Carson gave him about a 6-yard cushion, then had to come back late. And by that time, Presley had thrown it on the numbers. First down and 10 now at the Eagle 46. Mountaineers back in business, 6:51 to play. Shotgun snap. Presley throws over far side. Catch is made at the 42 and eventually brought down by Michael Butler is Tony Washington, the freshman out of High Point, North Carolina. But a good pickup on first down sets up second down and four on the six-yard gain. A long throw by Presley across his body to the far side. And Washington hauls it in. 6:26, clock moving, 7-0. Appalachian State with the lead, and the Mountaineers on the march.
Playing with such confidence, App State is. And you know, normally most wide receivers at the sideline would just run out of bounds. They're always trying to make a play after they catch the ball.
Working from the right hash mark, attacking right to left, Presley on the snap. Brent Russell had a hand on him, and Presley, as he tried to spread it wide, steps out of bounds at the 41. John Douglas forced him out. And with 6:06 to play, sets up third down and maybe a loss here. They'll say third down and about five.
And that's why tackles, when you play a spread option like this, you know, your defensive tackles have to play a little bit wider. Like you said, Presley's so fast off the snap out of the shotgun. If you go, it's all about angles. You go straight at him, you're going to miss him.
Yeah, Presley running downhill at the snap virtually every time. Third down and five at the 41 of the Eagles. Presley firing. Catch made at the 39, breaking a shoestring tackle, and Kay staying on his feet inside the 35 and finally out of bounds at around the 29-yard line. It's enough for an Appalachian State first down. Brian Quick again, and Terry mentioned 6'5", 220. Yeah, you go for the lower body. You better come up with a big stop, otherwise he's going to keep moving.
Again, making yards after the catch, trying to make a play, and a big-time play after the catch, and that's exactly what Quick did. He shut about four tackles off right there. If we'd have made the tackle, we'd have stopped him, but instead, he ends up picking another 5 or 6 yards off.
Brian Quick, 18 yards of reception, number one among active members in FCS football, and he showed it there. First down and 10 at the 29 of the Eagles. On the right hash, down 7-0. Defense got to find a way to make a stop here and make it quickly. Empty the backfield. Presley by his lonesome, fires far side. Catch is made down around the 10. It's Blake Elder, the senior out of Duncan, South Carolina, a product of Burns High School. And that will set up the Mountaineers' first down goal to goal at the 9.
One thing I hate, Ryan, you've heard me say it more than any time, breaking on the receiver versus being a ball hawk and breaking on the ball.
Yeah, trying to make a big hit, and he made that in Elder. And Elder is as sure hands as it gets and a good receiver of many in this Appalachian State offensive arsenal.
5:02, first quarter action. First down goal to goal at the Eagle 9-yard line. Mountaineers looking for more here early on in the first quarter. Twin backs with Presley out of a shotgun. Here's the snap. He'll give it off. It's Moore coming near side, trying to spread it out. Works his way inside the 5 and out of bounds at about the 3-yard line. Trying to stick the football over the goal line, but he's about 3 yards short of doing so. A.J. McCray made the stop on Devin Moore, the senior. Comes into the game, 62 carries, 197 yards on the season. Did not play in the opener against Chattanooga. He's got 5 touchdowns on the season and currently stands 8th all-time for Appalachian State rushing players. They'll say he was able to get the ball to the 1-yard line. Second down goal to go from the Eagle 1. Working from the left hash. Presley off again. Hands off to Devin Moore and easily walks in for the score. It's 13-0 with 4:29 to play here in the first quarter. And the Eagles have no answer for the Mountaineer offense thus far.
No, we don't. That was an 80-yard drive right there. 10 plays, 80 yards. Nice combination of running and passing the ball. The arm was the most, let me rephrase that. The receivers was the most important part of that drive for App State.
Guitarist on for the point after. Kick is up high into the air. Kick is good, and it's 14-0. The Eagles have spotted Appalachian State here at home. A 14-0 lead with 4:29 to play. We'll take a timeout. We'll return to Alan E. Paulson in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
I toured 6 different universities, applied and was accepted to 14. I was looking for a place that I would be happy, a place that could provide opportunities for me, a place that I could grow, be involved, a place where there would always be something to do. I did my homework. I wanted the perfect fit. I chose Georgia Southern University. The Georgia Southern campus gave me the feeling that I was looking for. I'm Annalie Ashley. I'm from Loganville, Georgia. I'm a freshman at Georgia Southern University, and I'm Georgia Southern True Blue. Are you?
Visit Georgia Southern University today, online at georgiasouthern.edu. With a new coach, a new offense, and a new attitude, it's a whole new ball game for Eagle football. And Loco's Grill and Pub is proud to be a longtime sponsor of the Georgia Southern Eagles. Speaking of football, whether it's the big game on TV or just a big night out, Loco's is the place to be in Statesboro. When you step in Loco's, you not only get a killer sandwich, some award-winning wings, or the perfect pint, you get something to go along with it, a great time. That's why Loco's is better than good, it's crazy good. Loco's Grill and Pub, 91 Briarwood Lane in Statesboro.
Back here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium, 14-0. Appalachian State with the lead, 4:29 to play here in the first quarter. 80-yard drive. And eventually Devin Moore gets in for his sixth touchdown of the season. And much like last week against Samford, Georgia Southern's offense unable to really move the ball, have any consistency. And you don't put that in the hands of the Southern Conference top scoring and top offensive team so far in 2010. Here's the kickoff, fielded at the 9 by LaRon Scott, far side. And eventually Appalachian State will bring him down at the 27-yard line. That's where Georgia Southern takes over. 4:22 to play, 14-0. Appalachian State with the lead. Georgia Southern football presented in part by the University Store, much more than just a bookstore. The University Store is your game day headquarters with exclusive Nike sideline gear, tailgating supplies, and gift for Eagle fans everywhere. Visit their campus location, game day stores at Paulson, or online anytime at gsustore.com. The University Store, official outfitters to the Georgia Southern Radio Network. So Jay Beauchamp and company step back on the field. They'll send two wide out to the right, one receiver. Left side of the field, Shaw comes out firing. Far side, caught at the 32. It'll be Mitch Williford making his way up near the first down sticks. Just shy, it appears, out of bounds, far sideline at the 36-yard line. But a good pickup on first down, having to go to the passing game, something you have to believe Georgia Southern will do today. Because as Terry said in the opening comments, Appalachian State knows what they want to do, and that's rushing the football, especially on the dive, and they'll load that box up all afternoon.
Yeah, dare you to beat us with your arm. Go ahead, try it.
Third down and a yard, rather second down and a yard here at the 36-yard line. Shaw puts it in the belly. Robert Brown, forward motion, he got it. He's moved backward, but he's up to the 38. And Jabari Fletcher made the stop, but it's enough for a Georgia Southern first down with 3:43 to play here in the first quarter.
First down of the day, I believe, if not mistaken. He's going to spot the ball at about the 39-yard line. This crowd wakes back up early in the ball game.
We talked about the importance of passing, maybe more important than that, the importance of getting yards and positive yards on first down. That will set up the ability to pass.
Appalachian State on the Toyota Game Tracker, 89 yards of offense, 80 of it coming on the last drive for the score. Shaw keeping. Stutter steps, gets across the 40, just shy of the 42-yard line. D.J. Smith, the leading tackler for the Mountaineers, a senior out of Charlotte, North Carolina, out of the football factory known as Independence High School, will make the stop.
Speed, speed. We talk about the Appalachian State offense's speed, Ryan. Their defense certainly can claim to have a little bit of as well.
And size. It's a combination. I mean, they're, you know, 15, 20 pounds heavier at most spots than we are, and then they got that speed.
2-yard pickup, sets up second down 8 at the 41-yard line. Shaw under center. Wilcox in motion. He'll give it to Robert Brown on the dive, and he will literally dive up to about the 44-yard line.
Got to try to get the dive game working. We haven't been able to do that the last few games. Trying to have some success here in the early part of the ballgame against App State. We've thrown two passes. Both of them have been the flats. Both of them have been successful. Look for that again.
Georgia Southern 0 for 2 on third downs this afternoon. Third and 5 at the 44.
Love to see that seam route still.
Two receivers to the left, one to the right side. Shaw looking to throw. Pressure comes. Throw across the middle. Great catch at the Appalachian State 48. T.J. Wilcox goes up, hauls it in, spins down to the turf. And it's a first down for Georgia Southern. Great catch by J.J. Wilcox in traffic. The ball was thrown where only J.J. could get it. But Wilcox, the sophomore out of Cairo, had to get up. A little bit of gymnastics to pull it down.
App State adjusts. They move the linebacker, shift him over the center, and bring him off left tackle. And that would have been the spot if he'd have gone back and backed into coverage where Wilcox made that catch. What a catch from Wilcox.
Very lucky that wasn't a pick.
First down this afternoon. Georgia Southern on the Mountaineer side of the field. Shaw keep it up the middle and get punished by D.J. Smith. Makes his way to the 47-yard line, but a crushing blow by Smith, who, again, the second member we've talked about from the Buchanan watch list, moved from Will linebacker to Mike due to the injury to Jeremy Kimbrough earlier in the season, but had really not lost anything moving from Will to Mike linebacker.
Southern showing an offset eye on that play. Robinson to the right of Brown.
Second down, 8 at the Mountaineer 46-yard line. Shaw, quick toss, comes to Wilcox, breaks one tackle, and eventually nothing but Mountaineers there. He fights off 2, and then finally John Reiser, the sophomore from Fayetteville, will bring him down for a loss of about a yard. It'll bring up 3rd and 9.
We just got flat out burned at the tackle. We missed the tackle. It was, in basketball, you'd call that windmill defense.
So 3rd down and 9. Final 40 seconds here of the first quarter. Georgia Southern down 14-0, trying to put something together. And they need a 3rd down conversion here, as they'll send 2 wide to the left, 1 to the lone side. Trey Butler, the true freshman, checks in as a wide receiver to the near side. Shaw under center. Pressure coming quickly. He'll throw it out to Butler, and nowhere close, incomplete at the 45. And that sets up 4th down and 9 with 15.5 seconds. The clock will stop, and Charlie Edwards will come on once again. So down 14-0, Georgia Southern moves into Mountaineer territory. But the drive will stall, and they'll give it back to this explosive Mountaineer offense as Cadet stands back at around the 10-yard line. Snap to Charlie. Appalachian setting up for a return. It's a high kick. Cadet will let it fall. Takes a bounce for Appalachian State at the 6. Rolls out of bounds at around the 13-yard line. And that's where Appalachian State will take over with 4.9 seconds remaining here in the first quarter. And they lead 14-0 on homecoming day at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Fans, want to remind you it's never too late to start or finish your college degree. Apply today for the new online Bachelor of General Studies at Georgia Southern University to start in January 2011. Visit online.georgiasouthern.edu to apply. Flexible, respected online, a new way to earn your degree from Georgia Southern. First down and 10 at the 12 is where they mark the ball with 4.9 seconds remaining here in the opening quarter of today's game. Presley takes the shotgun snap, moving near side, now cuts it back up the middle. Makes his way to the 15 before bulldozed there by E.J. Webb, and that will be the final play of the first quarter. So after 15 minutes of action, Appalachian State, the number one team in the land, leads 14-0 as we have a flag down. We'll wait and see what that's all about before they let the team switch sides of the field. A little discussion going on with Ed Rhodes, our referee, and his crew today. And we'll get the call momentarily. Triple zeros on the scoreboard here.
Illegal formation. 5 men in the backfield. That's a 5-yard penalty. We will have an untimed down. Untimed down.
So an untimed down upcoming here, as they'll reset first down on the penalty. 5 men in the backfield for Appalachian State. Puts the ball down at the Mountaineer 8-yard line. And Ryan, right now with the offense really not doing anything, you're calling on this defense not only to hold the number one offense in the Southern Conference and one of the top in the FCS, you're asking them to produce points.
Don't bend, don't break. That's a tough task.
First down, 15, just inside the 7-yard line. Give it off to Moore. He'll just head up, right tackle, make his way across the 10 to the 11, and that will end the first quarter of action. They'll switch sides of the field, as Appalachian State will face down a 2nd down and 11 when we return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. Your score after one quarter of action, Mountaineers 14, Georgia Southern nothing. You're listening to the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Now is the time. Now is the time to get to Superior Homes for the largest selection and on-the-lot inventory in Southeast Georgia. Choose from the best names in single wides, double wides, triple wides, even quad wides. Homes of Merit, Destiny, Fleetwood. Superior Homes has the home you want at the price you want to pay. Superior prices, superior products, and superior service. 301 South in Statesboro, or call 681-2122. That's 681-2122. Superior Homes.
Students have a real need for fast, affordable, high-speed internet. To meet that need, Frontier is pleased to introduce Frontier Fast High-Speed Internet for just $34.99 a month. Here's what's included. A dedicated, unshared connection that won't bog down during peak hours. No lengthy commitments. Our four-month price protection plans give you the best of both worlds, affordability and flexibility. And go wireless with our extended range wireless modem, perfect for all your wireless devices. Stop by our Frontier offices on East Grady Street in Statesboro to learn more. Early termination fees, taxes, and surcharges may apply.
Georgia Southern football presented in part by Bud Light. The sure sign of good times, the just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go. Bud Light reminds you to always drink responsibly and always designate a driver. Bud Light, proud sponsor of Georgia Southern Athletics as the Eagles honor the 1999 championship team here between first and second quarter. And Appalachian State looking at second down and 11. At their very own 12-yard line, leading Georgia Southern 14-0 as we begin the second quarter of action. And as I mentioned, Ryan, it's one of those deals where right now, if the Eagle defense can make a play and maybe put points on the board, maybe the only chance to get some momentum here early on in this first half of action.
Yeah, to start the rally, I guess, to use a baseball term.
Presley stands in the pocket, fires down the field, incomplete. At the 40-yard line, looking for Blake Elder. Good coverage that time by the Eagles. LaRon Scott, Michael Butler, and company, including Derek Hyden down there, into four Eagles.
And we were talking, you know, off the air that you feel like if you're Georgia Southern, if you're going to win this football game, you got to win the turnover margin. And you've already given one away, so now in your head, you got to get one back, and you got to get another one. And that's going to start from Georgia Southern defensive side of the ball, and no better time to do it now, 3rd and 11.
Appalachian State 3 of 4 on third downs today, staring down 3rd down and 11 here at their very own 12-yard line. They found a way to get out of this one like Houdini, and now they'll do the draw, and it's going to be Presley. He's got daylight, 20, 25, 30. Shakes off an arm tackle near side in the Eagle territory and out of bounds at the 48-yard line. And once again, they find a way to convert on third down and move the field position in one play. 14:45 to play, second quarter. And the Mountaineers on the Eagles' side of the field, somewhere they pretty much set up camp so far today.
Just an absolute simple draw as Georgia Southern didn't bring the extra. They were playing the man-to-man, so you see the corners turn. And when you see those back, if you're a running quarterback like DeAndre Presley, when you see the backs of the secondary turn toward you, you know they're in coverage, and you're going to have some daylight upfield if you get through the first line of defense.
Presley coming into the game 644 yards on the ground. Would much rather love to sit back and throw it, but can do it if he need be. Cadet with the handoff coming near side. Stopped at the 46-yard line, a pickup of 2 yards, 2nd down and 8.
It sounds weird. Third and long is actually a tough spot against the running quarterback because, again, if you play man, that's what he's looking for. He wants to see man in the secondary. Do you bring the blitz, and then all of a sudden you thin out that secondary a little bit, and you know how quick he can hit that hole. That shows you when you have a good quarterback like Presley in the shotgun how he can hurt you no matter the down and distance.
2nd down 8 at the Eagle 46. Give it off to Cadet. He's hitting the backfield. Josh Rowe got to him and drops him at the 46 back at the line of scrimmage. That time, good pursuit by Rowe. Good to see him back full health, the sophomore out of Opelika, Alabama. They'll set up 3rd down and 8, but so far today, 3rd down, for Appalachian State.
You know, between Rowe and Carson, you get 50%, you're lucky right now. Those guys aren't even near at 100%. And just the gut to get out here and try this thing on homecoming Saturday.
Trip receivers to the left, one lone receiver to the right side. Presley steps out, fires, and diving for the catch. Incomplete at the 40 is Toko Hillary. It's incomplete. And that will set up 4th down. And for the first time, Appalachian State will have to bring out. Check that. Sam Martin's been out here twice, so he will come out for the 2nd time today.
It doesn't feel like he's been out here. After the first 5 minutes, Georgia Southern felt like maybe they've got a little bit of momentum right out of the gate, the three and done. But, you know, I mean, when you put the ball on the ground and you give this kind of offense the opportunity to move it around a little bit, you take any kind of momentum you gain right out of the gate if you're Georgia Southern.
Martin averaging 37 yards a kick, puts this one high into the air. And this one will sail into the end zone for the touchback. Had a long of 54 on the season, and that one got caught up in the air, Ryan, and the wind carried it to the back of the end zone. 12:59 to play,
14-0. Georgia Southern takes over, first down and 10 at their very own 20-yard line.
It's blowing hard. Temperatures, you know, the cold front that's moving in for South Georgia, it's going to be cold from this point forward. But, you know, if you're on the radio dial, you're going left to right, blowing in behind Gene Bishop into the stadium right now. And if you got the wind to your back, you're going to have certainly a little bit more leverage in the kicking game, both kicking and punting.
So the Eagles back on the field, down 14-0. It's Shaw under center. Robert Brown, your fullback. Nico Hickey, an A-back. He'll lead block for Jabo Shaw, who comes around left side across the 20 and makes his way to about the 23-and-a-half-yard line. Mark Legree on the stop, senior out of Columbus, Georgia. Pacelli High School. Along with Dominic McDuffie on the stop for the Mountaineers. Pickup of 3 yards by Shaw. Second down, 7. Now mark it at the 23-yard line. Eagles attacking right to left on your dial. Working from the left hash mark is Shaw. Sends Hickey in motion. Quick toss, and Appalachian State knew it was coming, and they eat it up. Knocked the ball loose. Troy Sanders, great call. It's out of bounds, and it's out of bounds near side at about the 18-yard line. They blew that play up.
That's like a sack, and on second down, that's almost as bad as a turnover when you've got your back to the wall like this. And those are the mistakes. I mean, you know, Georgia Southern knew it was going to be a tough task and a tall order walking in against Appalachian State. But like I said in the pregame, I mean, you almost got to come out here and play perfect. You got to take advantage of every opportunity.
Third down and 12. Eagles have struggled on third down today, just 1 of 4. Shaw will step back to throw. Fletcher gives pressure. Hit as he's thrown. And a diving grab by Wilcox. Incomplete at the 45-yard line. And J.J. slow to get up. And Shaw took a blitzing smash from Jabari Fletcher as he let that ball go. And J.J. is down. And that is another costly Eagle you can ill afford to be without. 12:19 to play. Time on the field as they'll come out to take a look at Wilcox, who really, I think, just hit the ground hard trying to dive for the catch at the 45-yard line.
Just, you know, in the option, that's just a play action, almost sprint out, if you will, with the B-back coming through, and it's the seam route for Wilcox. And he's found a zone. They were playing zone there on the far side, and he was able to find that soft spot in the zone coming over once he passed the face of the linebacker into the secondary. The throw, as you said, was a little off after Jabo got hit, but Wilcox, with really nobody but 2 feet behind him, 2 feet in front of him, was able to lay out and get his hands on him, not able to come up with the catch. Good to see him walking off the field, but yeah, he just came down awkward, almost kind of doubled up over himself, almost like kind of like the half penny flip going out on the turf, but that could have been very costly, but it's good to see Wilcox up and going.
So he comes out on his own power to the near sideline. Now Edwards inside the Eagle 5 will kick it away. This time the wind in his face. This one in the air but hangs up high. Cadet calling for the fair catch. And Georgia Southern just nails him at the 40-yard line. And that'll be a flag, and that is another costly penalty.
He's claiming he was pushed into it. Dante Watkins running down the field may have a little bit of an argument there, feeling like he was pushed into him. He didn't see the fair catch. He leveled him. I guess if you're going to hit the guy late, go ahead and take him out. That's basically what he did. But just go ahead and hit him hard. I mean, go ahead and get away with it, I guess you could say. Not saying anything illegal on that one, but he was pushed into him in his mind. We'll see if they wave it off. I don't think they will, because he's still got to be in control.
There's a block in the back against a return team.
Wow. Wow.
Number 99.
Wow, Terry.
That caused the Georgia Southern player to hit the receiver.
Eagle eye,
that
Terry Harvin.
That flag is waved off. That'll be a 10-yard penalty against a return team. First down.
You know, Terry, you don't complain enough about the officiating.
My goodness. Man. I tell you what, guys, I'm gone for the rest of the day. Y'all have a good one. That's like having a great
drive. I can see him at home now.
Course.
Delete, 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 delete.
No kidding.
Wow.
My goodness.
Good call. He did go into him at full speed. It seemed like he had to get some kind of help. And I know Appalachian State's
Harbaugh,
not going to like that at all.
I get tired of the backspace.
All right, fair enough.
Well, now it's up to the Georgia Southern defense again, still staring at a 14-0 Appalachian State lead. Still plenty of time here in the second quarter, but Terry, again, offensively, just not much going on for Georgia Southern.
And it's not like this is the first game either. We've seen this the last three games, really, since the second half of App State or Chattanooga, just haven't been able to get anything going. Here they are. App State has the ball on their own 38-yard line.
So Presley will bring out the troops. Send two wide to the left side. One lone receiver to the near side. Play action. Quick fire. Catch is made at the 40. Cross midfield and diving into Eagle territory is B.J. Frazier, far sideline. To about the 49-yard line, and that's really the key for Appalachian State. They can run if they need be,
yeah.
But they can just find these receivers, Blake Elder, B.J. Frazier, Andrew Peacock, Brian Quick, Tony Washington, Matt Klein when he's healthy. They're there. Yeah. You have to find a way to stop five and six receivers on every play.
You pray you can bottleneck it up in the middle, but that leaves it very thin out in the secondary for that quick fire.
First down and 10 at the 48. Presley again firing, hit as he throws. And the catch is made at the 39-yard line. It's Coco Hillary coming up big and looks to be from the spot just a yard shy, 9-yard pickup as Presley took a shot there as he released.
It's created from the secondary. You have to be able to play off at the line because so much of your secondary protection this week is in the middle between the tackles in that box because they're so fast and winning that zone scheme. They're able to get the offensive line out there and protect. And you have to use so much of your safeties, your secondary in the middle.
Presley, shotgun snap, rolling to his right. Now he'll fire the deep ball down the field. Flag comes out.
Fair.
Quick says he is held up.
He was.
And that will be a pass interference call. The Eagles had coverage, but LaRon Scott and Michael Butler called for the pull of the jersey.
Yeah, it was obvious he did it around the 15-yard line. I saw it from here. I was wondering if that flag was going to come out. But Carson Hill, you know, needed quit complaining. He got burned. He grabbed the jersey to hold him. You know what? Not a bad penalty. I mean, if you're going to be burned, go ahead and take the penalty versus the touchdown because he was burned. He just yanked him by his jersey.
So Georgia Southern will be penalized once again, something that has also reared its ugly head here over the last several weeks.
Number 34 against an eligible pass receiver on a pass across the line. That's a 10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
All right, I guess my eyes are going on me, too. That was LaRon Scott that got the jersey.
Ed Rhodes explaining exactly what pass interference is all about.
He did a good job, didn't he?
Throw across the line, an eligible receiver. First down at 10 at the 29 after the automatic first down at 15 yards. 11:02 to play, second quarter, 14-0 Appalachian State leads. They'll scrimmage with the ball placed on the left hash mark.
Carlos Cave into the ball game. So is Olbeck.
Presley looking to throw. Quick fire. Short stuff underneath at the 25. It'll be B.J. Frazier. Will make his way down to about the 23-yard line. It's Mattingly on the stop. And Carlos Cave combining with 10:44. Clock moving. First half, 14-0. Georgia Southern trailing Appalachian State. And the Mountaineers knocking on the red zone door here, something they're very good at this season.
Cave backpedaling there, playing zone here on the near side for Georgia Southern, a good coverage.
Trip receivers left, one to the right. Presley gives the handoff. It'll be Moore. He splits defenders, and a flag comes out. Actually, five flags come out as he makes his way to the end zone, but all kinds of holding going on around the 14-yard line. That one's going to come back.
Remember the jersey that I thought Carson or LaRon Scott had? Basically, they have the entire jersey of Russell in that one. If that's a penalty against Southern, there's a real problem here because they really was dragging Russell down by his back jersey on that play.
Let's count them. One, two, three hankies come in.
There are two fouls on the play.
Uh-oh.
Holding. Offense, number 70. Personal foul, face mask. Defense, number one. Offset, second down.
Okay. Well, you could make an argument that there'd be no face mask if there were no hold, but to each their own.
Did I tell you it's a beautiful day for football, though?
second down four at the 23, so they'll replay second down. Presley out of the shotgun. He'll have two receivers to the left, one to the right, and Brian Quick. Westbrook showing blitz, and Presley will just keep right side. Find some room inside the 15 to about the 14-yard line. It's a first down for Appalachian State. Josh Rowe made the stop.
Well, that's where containment up front is key. You see him able to scrape off a tackle. Now you're asking your defensive end to not only the penetration, but then, you know, to make that lateral move. And Johnny Douglas, guys, let's not forget, is playing with a club on his left side. So anytime Presley goes right or toward the near side, you're asking Douglas to try to reach out there and just try to trip him.
First down 10 at the Eagle 14-yard line. Two receivers left. Again, Brian Quick lining up short side of the field to the right. Devin Moore on the wing to the left side of DeAndre Presley. Shotgun snap. Option. Here's the pitch. Presley gives it off to Moore. Nowhere to go. Dropped at the 19-yard line. Josh Rowe brings him down quickly. And Presley looked real uncomfortable running the option there. I don't think that's his strong suit.
No, it's certainly, well, not when you got Eubanks in your grill. I mean, that's kind of what happened on that one. He had to get rid of it a little sooner than he thought. Great play on that one. Josh Rowe taking the pitch, man. Eubanks taking the quarterback. You had Butler coming up to clean him up. That's good defense there.
So a loss on the play. Sets up second down 16 at the 19-yard line of the Eagles. Presley again out of a shotgun. Moore on a wing to his left side. Quick fire on his back foot. Throws this one in the end zone. LaRon Scott's got the interception. Georgia Southern will set it up first down and 10 at the 20-yard line. And Presley wants that one back because he threw that one falling backward.
He certainly was. And why he was falling backwards, Ryan E.J. Webb came in on the blitz, was all in his face. He threw it off his back foot up in the air. Normally he could get away with that because of those talented receivers. This time he underthrew it. LaRon Scott cut under and made the interception.
Just two goes and a seven in here to the near side in the back. And because of the support up front, it's one-on-one. And that was a terrible throw. And LaRon Scott turned into a receiver. And that kind of athleticism, he was going to have it all day.
All right, Ryan, Georgia Southern gets the turn of events.
Score
on turnovers
here, and you start this game over.
9:02 to play, second quarter. Plenty of time here in the first half. First down and 10 at the 20. Shaw fakes the quick toss, now rolls over, gets the pass out. Catch going to be made by Robinson. Far sideline, 30, 35, upended at the 37-yard line.
That was Brown coming out
Robert
of the
Brown.
Backfield. Great catch by the freshman receiver on that play. Hard to catch. He pulled up his hand, Chris, with his left hand and knocked it down. And that is a play that Robinson and we has made in the past.
First down and 10 at the 36-yard line. As Shaw comes to the near side, gets the play, now heads to the Georgia Southern huddle. Randavius Mann ready to snap it away. Send out Mitch Williford wide to the left side. Trey Butler wide to the right, working from the right hash mark. Shaw under center. Robert Brown, your fullback. Option, near side. Shaw, late pitch. Hickey's got it. He's at the 40. Spins away at the 45. And somehow, crab legs his way to the 45-yard line of Appalachian State. First down, Georgia Southern. Great play and great call by J-Bo Shaw. He sucked the defense in at the very last minute. Made the pitch to Hickey, who was at full speed. And what can you say about the way Nico made his way down the field?
Where Shaw may lack in speed at times, he certainly makes it up with that mental capacity as he sucked him in and knew exactly when to pitch it off. A great second effort by Hickey.
First down 10 at the Appalachian State 45-yard line. Just the second time today Georgia Southern seen their side of the turf. Shaw again faking the quick toss. Stands in the pocket, has time, fires this one. This one's loose. Didn't come out good, and the receiver fell down at the 25. J.J. Wilcox. And luckily, Appalachian State not able to make a play on it.
Great coverage by Appalachian State. Actually threw it, and I was going to say quadruple coverage on that play. Wilcox fell down, Ryan, but really an ill-advised pass by Shaw, who I think was just trying to squeeze something in there.
Again, more zone. We've seen the blitz. New defensive coordinator for Appalachian State this year. You'll see more blitzes. They've been blitzing, especially from the corner spot, and they're asking their secondary to do a lot of zone, and Wilcox has found it now twice.
Second down, 10 at the 45. Of the Mountaineers, J-Bo Shaw under center. Send Hickey in motion. Option. Shaw will keep brought down by his ankles, and Shaw not happy with it at all as he's dropped at the 42. Bobby Bazo, the senior. And there's a Mountaineer slow to get up. And it is Bobby Bazo. No, check that. It's Jabari Fletcher a little slow to get up now. He's going to make his way to the far sideline. They'll send in Jason Jones, a junior out of Charlotte, North Carolina.
But Bazo's checking out, too, if you notice, because he got up slow. Both of them did. They were on top of each other. Big third down conversion here, third and seven.
They're missing senior and senior on that right side of the defensive line on third down and seven at the 42. Shaw. Sprint out right side. Now he'll tuck it back in and run 40 and diving to to the 36-yard line is Jay Shaw, and he is just shy of the first down. We'll see where the spot comes, and I have to believe with 7:05 to play, Georgia Southern may roll the dice.
The App State judge, Axel Line, gave us a better spot than the sideline for Georgia Southern did on that one.
They're going to bring in the change. Check it.
Yeah, that's going to be close on that one. Good effort by Jabo, but you're right on the money. I would be surprised if we didn't go for it. We're out of field goal range with the win.
So they'll bring the chains from the far side. 7 minutes even to play second quarter. Mountaineers lead 14-0. Georgia Southern finally coming to life offensively here on homecoming day, and it will be just shy of a couple of inches. And, of course, the crowd here at Paulson doing their best to lobby Coach Munkin.
Oh, yeah.
He
obliges.
I don't think he needed any
lobby.
I mean, they could have booed. It wouldn't have made any difference.
Jabo Shaw will come into the huddle, set the play with 7 minutes to go in the second quarter. Third down and about 6 inches. And they'll line it up. Shaw under center, Robert Brown, your fullback. And if you're Georgia Southern, there has to be a last-minute message. Hold on to the football.
Quick pitch.
Shaw will keep, and he will get it inside the 35 and the 34-yard line. First down, Georgia Southern. So they keep the drive alive. They've struggled on third down today. But the deepest they have been in Mountaineer territory as they try to platoon the defensive front. Jerry Moore and company trying to keep everybody healthy.
And it couldn't happen a better time as you try to wind down this clock with 6 minutes to go in halftime. Be good to get in with a score. Seventh play of the drive, Chris.
First down and 10 at the 34 of Appalachian State. Wilcox in motion. Again, they'll fake the quick toss. Shaw stands in the pocket, throws this one into coverage, and it'll be interception. That was easy to take away. I think Dominique Duffy, McDuffie, came away with the INT, and that was well overthrown, thrown into triple coverage, and Appalachian State will turn away Georgia Southern once again with 6:15 to play here in the second quarter. They'll take over first down and 10 at their very own 20-yard line.
Good defensive back coverage. Threw it into double coverage, but they had Nico Hickey covered very well, and Nico not able to climb up over those guys to make the play. You get the INT in the end zone, and App State able to stop Georgia Southern here with another turnover. First down and 10 for the Mountaineers, starting on their 20.
They're a great defensive secondary. Throwing the ball down the field, you really take a risk with the Mountaineer defensive backs. First down and 10 at the 34. Simple handoff, Devin Moore. Or rather at the 20, Devin Moore will take the handoff, make his way to about the 23-yard line, a pickup of three, maybe four. Set up second down, they'll say seven here with under 6 minutes to play in the second quarter, down 14-0. And again, I go back to the defense having to make some plays. They're going to have to score some points, are the Georgia Southern defense. Presley, trip receivers left, one to the right. Give it off again. It'll be Moore. And ball comes loose. Georgia Southern says they have it. Ed Rhodes in there as Derek Hyden trying to lobby his part. Ed Rhodes says it is. Ed Rhodes still looking around. Ed Rhodes says, and we're still talking.
Yeah, he went into the pile. He lost it. I'm behind the line of scrimmage. He went into the pile, and he lost it.
Whoa. E.J. Webb comes out of the pile with the ball. Even the Appalachian State offense went ahead and went to the sidelines. If that doesn't tell you something, I'm not sure what does. E.J. Webb came out of the bottom with the ball, folks.
So Ed Rhodes took seconds.
I'm looking at a still shot. Yeah. Oh, wow. Boy, did they just miss that.
And that's that Southern Conference huddling referees. They love to do it. Best in the country. Presley keeps it. And he's cut down at the 24-yard line by E.J. Webb. Now you hate to see it.
Yeah.
But that will be a fourth down upcoming for the Mountaineers, and they will send out Sam Martin to punt it away.
I'm looking at another shot, guys. He is literally on both feet, and the ball is on the ground. He is on both feet. He hasn't gone down yet. That is absolutely amazing. Please, hey, save that picture.
4:38 to play. Darius Robinson back deep, or rather Darion Robinson back deep at the 30. Sam Martin will punt it away. Gets it away in traffic. Fair catch called for in traffic. Short kick. And Robinson will field it. They'll mark it down at the 44-yard line of Georgia Southern with 4:25 to play. 14-0, second quarter action. Georgia Southern's offense, maybe it's kind of like the little engine that could. Started out very slow. Last drive moved down the field, an interception took it away, but maybe Georgia Southern can get it on track here with 4:25 to go here in the first half.
Well, both you and Ryan said the defense need to figure out a way, and they just did. They had them a turnover, had that taken away. They forced a punt. Now need offense to click again.
First down, 10 at the 44. Eagles attacking right to left. Ball placed middle of the field. Jabo Shaw, traditional triple option. He's got Wilcox and Robinson as your A-back. Robert Brown, your fullback, and a receiver to each side. Here's the snap. Gives off the ride, Robert Brown, and dangerously carrying that football, but somehow makes his way to midfield. Picks up six, second down and four, as John Reiser, the sophomore out of Fayetteville, made the stop. But Brown has got to find a way to cover that football up. Loves to hang it out there.
Man, certainly does. Driving us crazy. And if you know what's driving us crazy, it's killing the coaches. As you hear the table being banged on quite a bit next to me. Frustrations abound everywhere.
Under 4 minutes to play. Second down, four at midfield. Shaw, Wilcox, Robinson, your A-back. Brown, your fullback. Receiver to each side, Trey Butler and Williford. Option, right side. Shaw, pitch to Wilcox, far sideline, brought out of bounds at about the 47-yard line of Appalachian State.
Got a player down for App State on about the 49-yard line, grabbing his head area, actually, as he's sitting there really slow to get up. Hope the young man's okay. Don't like to see that.
Dominic McDuffie, slow to get up on that far sideline. They say he got out of bounds, did Wilcox, with 3:44 to play. The clock will be stopped, obviously, for the injured Appalachian State Mountaineer, who is on his back near midfield. It looks like Brandon Greer, the Will linebacker, sophomore out of Charlotte, is who they are attending to.
Bring about third down and two, Chris.
While they take a moment with 3:44 to play, let's pause for a timeout. We'll return to Alan E. Paulson Stadium. Appalachian State up 14-0 over Georgia Southern. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
What do you look for in a teammate? Speed? Power? Dependability? Then it's time you looked at joining Team Tundra. Lease a new 2011 Toyota Tundra Double Cab for $289 a month for 36 months with $3,288 due at signing for qualified lessees. Cannot combine with other offers. Must complete sale and delivery between November 2nd and November 30th, 2010. Join the team at your local Toyota dealer. Toyota, moving forward.
Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair, and nobody shows more pride than Georgia Southern fans. And the University Store can help you show your true blue every day at work or at play. With exclusive Nike sideline gear, Under Armour, and Russell Athletic apparel, make it clear that you bleed Georgia Southern blue. You can shop their campus location, their game day locations at Paulson Stadium, or online anytime at gsustore.com. Helping you be true blue every day. Show your Eagle pride with a visit to the University Store. More than just a bookstore. The official outfitter to the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Jabo Shaw on third down and one, keeps it left side, makes his way inside the 45 of Mountaineer territory to the 44 for the first down as Brandon Greer, the sophomore outside linebacker for Appalachian State, has helped off of the field. And it will be first down and 10 for 44. Appalachian State leading 14-0, 3:09 to play. And Georgia Southern in a similar place they were last time. And that's inside Mountaineer territory before they have thrown the interception down in the end zone. Shaw on the keeper, and he'll be buried. DJ Smith drops him behind the line, though, giving forward motion to just shy of the 43-yard line as we're under 2:50 to play here in the second quarter.
So important to make that block on the linebacker. You're not going to get anywhere on that play, and that's exactly what happened. Wilcox not able to get to DJ Smith, who read it well. Second nine, 2:35 left to go until half, and, you know, we got to be very close to being field goal position with this wind in our face.
2:28, Shaw under center. He'll roll back, looking to throw, has time, fires this one, catch is made at the 35-yard line, right at the first down sticks. Mitch Williford has it, should be enough for a Georgia Southern first down. Let's see, they say a yard shy. Yeah, about a yard shy, 9-yard pickup.
Again, we're going to be in two-down territory anyway. Third down and one, ball spotted on about the 35, and the wind is certainly, from the flags, Ryan, looks pretty hefty.
Yeah, you're into the wind right now.
Georgia Southern and Appalachian State both with three timeouts remaining here as we hit the 1:49 mark here in the second quarter. Third down and a yard at the App State 35-yard line. Shaw under center. Brown, your fullback. Give the right off to Brown. Brown should have the first down as he hits into the pile to the 34-yard line. Stop the clock momentarily as they move the chains with a minute 35. As coming out of the game, Mitch Williford headed into the game will be Tyler Sumner as a receiver. First down, Georgia Southern, 1:35 to play second quarter. Appalachian State leading 14-0.
Again, the crowd is all the way around the hill near the scoreboard area. Good to see this large crowd in attendance today.
First down, 10 at the 34. Working from the right hash, Shaw, quick snap, pump fakes. Now fires this one deep, but this one is thrown away far side into the concrete bricks across the way, looking for Trey Butler.
Good pass, because he threw it where it couldn't be caught by anybody right before he took a sack. He was zoned in on one fade route right there to Butler. It wasn't there. He threw it away. If he had had more time, he would have saw Robinson on his left up the hash mark wide open. But at least he didn't throw in coverage, Ryan.
Well, what that does as a veteran, it simplifies things when you're in the pocket on a sprint out. If you're throwing down the sidelines, you know you just let it go a little bit too far and you can live to see another down.
Patrick Barker checks in as a receiver far side. Tyler Sumner to the near side. Second down and 10 at the 34 with 1:13 to play. The draw to Robert Brown, who just didn't get his foot right. And he'll be brought down for a loss. He made it back to the 35-yard line before hit, but it's a loss of a yard. It'll set up third and 11 and a timeout called by Georgia Southern with 1:02 to play. We'll take a timeout. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. Your score, Appalachian State 14, Georgia Southern nothing. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Ryan Chambers here from the Georgia Southern Radio Network, talking with Mike Williams of Olive Branch Landscape, who rescued my disaster of a yard.
Well, it wasn't as bad as you make it seem, Ryan, but people would be amazed at what a brand new yard does for the value of their home.
I knew you did great commercial work, but you guys service just as many homes.
Well, Olive Branch is not just about grass, trees, and shrubs, Ryan. We create patios, driveways, walkways, pavers, outdoor kitchens. We take care of all of your outdoor needs.
You can go see for yourself by visiting olivebranchlandscape.com.
This is Adam Hebert from Ag South Farm Credit. Whether it's a single acre to build that special dream home or a few hundred acres for that dream weekend hideaway, call the winning team at Ag South Farm Credit.
That's right, Adam. This is Rodney Fowler, and for over 90 years, we have specialized in making real estate loans, and no one does it better. As a cooperative, Ag South sends our profits to our members, last year to the tune of $21 million.
Convenient service, competitive, fixed rates, and loans that pay you. Call Adam, Rodney, or me, Josh Martin, at 764-9091. Ag South is an equal housing lender.
Back at Allen E. Paulson Stadium, 1:02 to play. Georgia Southern, or rather Appalachian State, leading 14-0. Eagles call the timeout, their first of the half. They have two remaining. Appalachian State with all three remaining. I would love to maybe get out of here and go into the locker room, leading 14-0. Georgia Southern with the ball placed down, third and 11 at the Mountaineer 35-yard line.
And at 0-5 to go, as we said, not in field goal range because of the wind. Two down territory.
Shaw already thrown his second interception of the season after throwing his first last week. Bobbles the snap, picks it up, backs up, sets up the screen. Robinson has it, 35, cuts back against the grain, near side at the 25, back to the near sideline to the 15. First down, Georgia Southern. If you don't have the play, just improvise, gentlemen.
Love that kick. I love that extra effort that Robinson gives. The kid doesn't seem to give up. I mean, the kid should have been tackled back there. Great play.
Credit J-Bo Shaw. Well, you talk about guts. Instead of diving on it on third and 11, he knew that would be a death nail. He decides to pick it up and hits Robinson near side. First down and 10. Sprint out right side. Shaw in trouble, and Hill will throw this one away wisely, stopping the clock with 37.4 seconds. It'll set up second down and 10 at the Mountaineer 14-yard line. This one is crucial. You're inside the red zone. Georgia Southern on the season, 90% in scoring, 63% in touchdowns. But after you spot the Mountaineers 14 points to start the first quarter,
yeah,
you have to get in here.
Oh, you got a halftime 14-7 after you give up two touchdowns? Yeah, and another great pass by Shaw by throwing it out of bounds. Stops the clock, second down and 10, ball in the 15. 37.4 seconds left to go on this homecoming beautiful Saturday at Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
Second down, 10 at the 14, working from the left hash. Georgia Southern may can go back to their power. Nope, they'll go to throwing. Throw far side, long throw, and it's incomplete at the 8-yard line to J.J. Wilcox. And with 32.8 seconds, they stare down third down and 10 at the 14, and they abandon the running game, go to the passing game.
Shaw keeps it low to Wilcox, and it's good in one respect that it's not going to be picked off in another. It's a very small window not only to make the throw, but for Wilcox, it's a very small window to almost get the knees bent and try to get a grip on it.
Well, I have to tell you, when it came off his hands, I was thinking this is going to be an App State touchdown. So I'm glad he underthrew it.
Third down, 10 at the 14. Georgia Southern on the afternoon. 4 of 9 on third down conversions. This one the biggest of the game thus far. Looking to throw. Shaw in trouble. Will tuck it. Run. He's to the 10. He's to the 5. Ball comes out in the end zone. It looked like Patrick Barker fell on it. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. Jabo Shaw is slow to get up, but the Eagles will put 6 on the board as Patrick Barker, who has missed so many games with injuries this season, comes in, picks up the loose football. And wait a minute. Oh, we've got a touchdown signal. Now Ed Rhodes says it's a first down.
What?
What? It was fumbled in the end zone.
What? Wait, whoa. What?
How is that?
He wasn't. Is he saying he was down? Oh, my goodness.
From the spot of the fumble, because you can't have a forward fumble. They're saying from the spot of the fumble, which is on the 3-yard line.
Somebody better tell the officials that's the rule.
Yeah, you get one touchdown call. Wow.
And it's first down goal to go, but only 20 seconds and the clock is moving. And Jarrett McKinnon has to check in, the freshman quarterback out of Marietta. Will keep it, go left side. He will power his way down to the 1. Looked like he got in. Nobody gave it to him.
Nobody gave us the timeout either.
And with 7.4 seconds, Georgia Southern will call a timeout.
Coach Monken.
Georgia Southern. And now their second of the half.
Another player down in the middle, an offensive lineman down in the middle. Chris, as I said, nobody would give us a timeout either. Jeff Monken and the players all signaling timeout. McKinnon, they thought he got in. Not, but literally Monken running out on the field trying to get the attention of the officials to give us a timeout on that play.
Coach Monken is going to ask for the officials. He still wants an explanation on the first signal touchdown, and then at that time McKinnon was awful close to breaking the play.
Well, it's been an interesting first half, to say the least, with 7.4 seconds. We've had touchdown calls taken away. And Eagles now starting to fall down on the field, as slow to get up, I believe, was Blake DeBartolo. He will be helped off by the training crew to the near side.
Hope y'all realize how much that hurts us on the offensive line.
Yeah, you can. I'm getting a ruling here. You can advance into the end zone. The actual ruling on the field was that he was down.
He was down.
Well, so, I mean, that was the second. The first ruling was touchdown. The second ruling was he was down. So they'll go with the second.
Wow.
Well, you know, usually you see that official coming and pointing ball, you know, down, but they didn't.
7.4 seconds to play, second quarter, second down goal to go at the Mountaineer 4-yard line. Jabo Shaw will check back in at quarterback after being banged up on the fumble, can't advance fumble, touchdown, not a fumble. But he was injured in that play, but now he'll step back in. They'll say second down, goal to goal, just inside the 2-yard line. And Jabo Shaw now comes out to talk to Ed Rhodes. We're waiting for them to give us an indication to start playing. Now the whistle blows and they're ready. Shaw under center. Robert Brown, your fullback. Appalachian State, everybody in the box. Shaw follows through. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern. And this one will stand. 14-6 with 5.1 seconds to play. Adrian Mora will come on for the point after as Jabo Shaw on the season picks up his 8th touchdown of the year.
keeps on the right side. Chris falls behind William Maxwell to get in for the score, making it no doubt a touchdown. And the coaches next door not happy about it either.
So more on for the point after. Kick on its way from Adrian, on its way, and good. 14-7, 5.1 seconds to play. It took a while, but the Eagle offense has shown up here for homecoming 2010. We'll take a timeout, return to Alan E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
Okay, back when moonwalking was hip, the Eagles were fielding their first football team. Six national championships later, they have truly dominated the competition. Talk about legendary. Like Ford F-150, it hauls more, tows more, and gets more out of a gallon of gas. That's why for 33 straight years, F-Series has been America's number one selling truck. Legendary champions, legendary truck. F-150, built for tough. Visit your local Ford dealer or log on to shopfordnow.com today. Classes full-size pickups under 8,500 pounds GBWR when properly equipped.
Today we salute you, Mr. Stadium Scoreboard Marriage Proposal Guy. Your first proposal, her hand in marriage. Your second proposal, two more jumbo chili dogs.
Chili cheese!
It's the perfect plan, unless her name is spelled wrong. She's in the bathroom, or she says no.
Pretty please!
So crack open an ice cold Bud Light, Mr. Bachelor, on the big screen.
Mr. Stadium Scoreboard Marriage Proposal Guy.
Bud Light Beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
With 5.1 seconds remaining here in the second quarter, a crazy end of the second quarter thus far, but it's 14-7. Georgia Southern gets on the board. Checking your Toyota game tracker, Appalachian State, 172 yards of total offense, 69 of that on the ground, 103 through the air. Georgia Southern now 145 yards of total offense, 70 of that through the air, and on the ground so far 75 yards for Georgia Southern. Eagles on that drive, 14 plays, 56 yards, took 4 minutes and 20 seconds, took a little longer than maybe they needed to, according to the officials, but it's 14-7 now, Appalachian State with the lead, and Edwards with a line drive kick down on the turf, fielded at the 10 by Cadet, near side, trying to bounce back to the middle of the field, and he'll be brought down at the 20-yard line. Georgia Southern game tracker delivered by your Southeast Toyota dealer, proud sponsor of Georgia Southern football. Toyota moving forward. That'll be the end of the first half. 14-7, Appalachian State with the lead. Let's head down on the field. Ryan Chambers will catch up with head coach Jeff Munkin.
All right, coach, that's a gutsy drive, a big play by Robinson, and then the big score from Shaw. How important is it this opening drive to keep the momentum?
Well, we've got to try to get some more points and do something on offense. I'm disappointed we turned the ball over. You know, the first kickoff wasn't good, and get a drive out there and we fumble the ball, and you know, we can't make those mistakes against a great football team like F. So hopefully we just settle down, come out and play a better second half, and it was a great drive by our offense, and I'm glad we got some points before half.
Let's go get them in the second half, coach.
Guys.
Thank you, Ryan. 19-48, halftime underway here, homecoming 2010, 14-7 Appalachian State leading over Georgia Southern, but the Eagles able to get in after struggling the entire first half. On offense, coming up, the Southern Halftime Report presented by the Georgia Lottery. Russ Brown and Terry Harvin will take you through the first half stats and highlights and much more as we continue on homecoming 2010 from Alan E. Paulson Stadium. Your score at the break, Appalachian State 14, Georgia Southern 7. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
If somebody yells Georgia, I yell Southern. My answer to whose house is always our house. And my favorite drive is Southern Drive because it takes me around Sweetheart Circle. My favorite colors are blue and white. But I'm also a little partial to the yellow on an old yellow school bus. I am a diehard, enthusiastic, lifetime supporter of Georgia Southern University. I am Georgia Southern. True blue. Are you? Visit Georgia Southern University online today at georgiasouthern.edu.
Back here at Alan E. Paulson Stadium, getting set for the start of the second half. 14-7, Appalachian State leads over Georgia Southern. Welcome back, Chris Blair, Terry Harvin, Ryan Chambers along with you on a very cool but sunny Saturday afternoon for homecoming 2010. And Terry, Georgia Southern will receive the ball to get things started here. And you got to feel pretty good down 14-7 on your home field after Appalachian State really in the first 8 minutes of this game just took it to you.
Oh, yeah, they owned us. Like I said, it was nightmarish looking you thought about last year. And then somehow we hung on. The defense played better. App State played worse. Kept us in the ball game. The offense got something going at the end there before halftime, even after turning the ball over. Overcoming some poor officiating helped us out a little bit. And extra effort, I mean, on that, the first half, I think of Robinson. That extra effort on third down made that drive possible because he should have been tackled, but he found a way to get the extra yards, Chris, to get the first down, and that's what it's going to take, is some key Eagles to figure out to make the play. Make the play.
Appalachian State will be kicking off to the Eagles. Time now for the second half kickoff presented by Geico Insurance. As this kick sails near side, fielded by LaRon Scott at the three near side. And LaRon tripped up, had a little bit of room, but is brought down at the 24-yard line. Fans, hurry into the Alltel Wireless trade-in, trade-up event and get $25 in instant savings. For a limited time, trade in your existing phone in good condition and trade up to any of the great smartphones Alltel has to offer, including the Motorola Milestone and Android technology, and get $25 in instant savings. So bring your phone to your nearest Alltel store, trade up and save. Details at your local Alltel store. Alltel Wireless, the official wireless provider of the Georgia Southern Radio Network. Just underway, third quarter, 14-7, Georgia Southern on the attack. First down and 10 at their very own 24-yard line. Shaw, give it off to Robert Brown, and Robert Brown spins around a couple of Mountaineers, makes his way up to the 29-yard line, a pickup of about five. It'll set up second down and five for the Eagles offense, who really came alive late in that second quarter. They gave up the interception driving into Mountaineer territory, and then after that came back, eventually got the score. But it seems like maybe they've warmed up a little bit, figured something out up top here in the booth, and are relaying it down on the field. But as Terry said, it's got to come to some gut check play by the offensive line and offensive players for the Eagles, looking at second down and five at their very own 29-yard line. Two receivers left as now Robinson motions left to right. Give the ride off to Robert Brown across the 30. Makes his way to the 32-yard line. Sets up third and about three. Very short and manageable here on third down with 14:05 clock moving here in the third quarter. 14-7, Appalachian State leads by a touchdown.
Bobby Bazo makes the play on that one. The nose guard tackle as he just penetrated, knocked our lineman in there. Brown had nowhere to go. Third down and two. Big play here.
Georgia Southern, third and two at the 32. Shaw, option, pitch. Coming to Robert Brown. Brown breaks a tackle and across the 35, far sideline. Out of bounds at the 39, first down and 10, Georgia Southern.
Nice delay pitch there to Brown, able to pick up a little high step there on the App sideline to get the first down and to move the chains. Good way to start the second half. Ball spotted at the 39-yard line.
Working from the right hash, Eagles attack right to left on your dial. They'll send out Barker wide to the short side of the field, which is the right side. Two receivers to the left as they'll put Darion Robinson in a slot near side. Robert Brown, J.J. Wilcox, Jabo Shaw under center with 5 seconds on the play clock. First down and 10 at the 39. Give the right off to Brown. Good read by Shaw as he crosses the 40, makes his way to the 44-yard line. Just another quick attack, and Appalachian State doing their best to bring them down quickly. And that time, Jabari Fletcher, who was banged up in the first half, back into the game, moving from the right end position, able to come across and bring down Robert Brown. Looking at second down and five. Now with the ball placed at the 30, or rather 44-yard line of their very own. Georgia Southern still on the move. Same formation. Robinson in a slot near side. Trey Butler wide out to the left. Barker wide to the right. Off to Robert Brown across the 45. Right up the gut, makes his way to the 47-yard line. It'll set up third and a short two upcoming for the Georgia Southern offense.
That's the only play that Shaw has, but Jabari Fletcher coming down on him hard like that. I mean, as soon as he hands it off, Shaw's getting a nice little pop from Fletcher, the senior out of Grady High School in Atlanta. 6'3", 265 defensive end who's been a stellar defensive end for them.
Third down two at the 47-yard line. Ball placed middle of the field. Shaw under center. Wilcox in motion. Shaw will keep it. Trying to follow behind. Right tackle. Powers his way across midfield to Mountaineer territory at the 49. First down and 10, Georgia Southern.
Wow, good extra effort, Ryan, by Shaw.
Yeah, and the blocking was good, but the running was better. And just willing themselves. If you remember the Elon game, when we started getting that pitch game going, guys, in the second quarter, it was because 3, 4, 5 yards on the dive in the first play on the first and 10 mark. And maybe we see that same thing here.
7 of 12 on third down conversions so far on the day.
First down at 10 at the 49. Eagles keeping it on the ground here in the opening play of the third quarter of action. Shaw option, near side, pitch coming to Brown. Trying to get around some tacklers. Makes his way to the 47. T.J. Smith, though, eventually able to come through and make the stop.
You know what Monk is saying to him? You got to run, son. Yeah. You got to run. Quit tiptoeing.
It's going to come. I mean, it's a different style of running, and he still hasn't completely learned it. I mean, you dance around a little bit when you play more of the I formation or pro-style stuff that you do in high school. And here, when you're that B-back, whether you're getting the pitch and you're coming through tackle, you got to go.
Because he had the block by Robinson Munkin running right over to Brown, coaching him as he was tackled.
They'll set up Wilcox in the slot far side. Williford wide out to the left side. Second down 9 at the Appalachian State 48-yard line. Motion Wilcox. Give it off to Brown. Right side. Brown spins his way to the 40-yard line. About a yard shy of the first down, but a pickup of 8 yards. Brown did a good job at that time finding the hole. Seems like he must have listened to Coach Munkin.
He must have listened about running hard and on that play. That's the second time we've seen this in the second half. We didn't see it in the first half, and that's Brown going off tackle on the right-hand side. You saw him up the middle the whole time in the first half. Now we're seeing going off of right tackle, a little broader approach.
10:07 to play third quarter, 14-7. Appalachian State leads. Georgia Southern staring down third down and 1 at the Mountaineer 39-yard line. This time Robinson steps in a slot left side. Now he'll motion left to right. Shaw under center. Shaw will keep, and Shaw will be dropped by Jabari Fletcher, who, as Terry said, has been there virtually every snap. And he is just shy of the 38-yard line. It will be very, very short, fourth and inches, and Georgia Southern appears to leave the offense in, go for it here.
I don't know why we wouldn't at this time. Like I said, you're out of field goal range. You might as well give it a crack at it. You've given App State better field position than this before. You've picked it up on it before. You could fall forward with Shaw. A quick pitch to Robinson might pull it off as well, as App State lines up with almost everybody in the box.
Georgia Southern 60% on fourth down conversions this year. 1 of 1 this afternoon. 4th and 1, less than a yard at the 39-yard line of the Mountaineers. Option. Shaw will keep it. He's got the first down. He's buried hard, but he's down inside the 35 to the 34. D.J. Smith laid the lick, but it's first down and 10, Georgia Southern, and J-Bo Shaw, like the trooper, hops up, hits back to the Eagle huddle.
Again, Ryan, great read. Everybody squeezed in between tackles. He took it around the right tackle.
Yeah, they sail off there on the right side, and Shaw saw it immediately. There was no hesitation. Again, watch for the pitch. The pitch game will loosen up if this continues.
First down 10 at the 34-yard line. Opening drive of the third quarter. Appalachian State up 14-7, 8:46 to play, third quarter action. Robinson motions left to right. Give the ride off. Robert Brown stood up, breaks one tackle, but makes his way to the 31-yard line, a pickup of 3, second down and 7, as the entire interior front for the Mountaineers makes the stop.
11th play of the drive, the opening drive of the third quarter. Scripting it very well, following the game plan. Second down and about... what, a long 7?
Long 7 upcoming. 8:15, clock moving, third quarter. Send out Williford wide to the left. Robinson again in the slot, left side. Working from the right hash, Robinson motions left to right. Snap. Little confusion. Shaw will step back. He'll throw this one. Got a man open. Wilcox, he's got it at the 18. Trying to break away from a shoestring tackle. Gets back to the 18-yard line. First down and 10, Georgia Southern. And J.J. Wilcox wanted it more than the Mountaineers. And coming up upset that time was Justin Ray, the outside linebacker. Thought he could make a play on the interception. And just started to bang the turf here at Glenn Bryant Field as he let that one get away. But great concentration by Wilcox sets up the Eagles first down and 10 at the Mountaineer 14-yard line.
Great concentration by Shaw to stay firm in the pocket and deliver that pass.
First down 10 at the 14, working from the left hash. Shaw with Wilcox, Robinson, and Brown in the backfield. Shaw, pitch, Robinson, near side, breaks a tackle at the 10 and then brought down at the 4-yard line. A pickup of nearly 10 yards should be enough to set up first down and goal. As Mark Legree had to make the stop for the Mountaineers. Let's see if they mark it. They'll say he's just shy inside the 6-yard line. It'll be second and a long yard here with 7:13 to play in the third quarter.
Wow, great effort again by Robinson. Love this kid. Love that extra effort he gives. Again, should have been tackled on the pitch. Was able to get by and good blocking downfield.
Robinson, the sophomore out of Athens, Georgia, 218 yards on the season coming into the game with 2 rushing touchdowns. Second down, 1 yard at the 5-yard line of Appalachian State. Shaw, he'll keep, go right tackle. Shaw's got the first down, set it up, first down, goal to goal at the Mountaineer 4-yard line. Dan Wiley on the stop, the junior out of Washington, Georgia. Washington Wilkes high school product, 6'1", 280.
Riding behind Brett Moore, the senior out of Warner Robins High School, Northside High School, who's having a great year in their playoff run. Also running behind William Maxwell out of Quitman.
It's protect the football time here for Georgia Southern. Under 6.5 minutes to play. First down, goal to goal. They'll put the pigskin down at the 3-yard line, placed middle of the field. Eagles break the huddle. Brandavius Mann will put his nose over it. Get ready to snap it to Jabo Shaw, the junior quarterback out of Flowery Branch, Georgia. Quick snap. Shaw going right side, and he gets buried, and it is D.J. Smith again. He's had his number several times. Got to about the 2, maybe a yard gain. That's it. It'll be first down, rather second down, goal to goal from the Mountaineer 2 is relaying the play. Mitch Williford will come in. Tyler Sumner will check out to the near side.
D.J. just coming in. Just easy read for him. That might open up the pitch. This is the 16th play of the drive, folks. Started on their own 24-yard line.
First down, goal to goal at the Mountaineer 2-yard line. Shaw calls for Robinson in motion. Quick toss, near side. Robinson buries the shoulder, rolls in. Ball came loose, but they say he broke the plane. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern, 14-13 with 5:33 to play as Darion Robinson picks up his 3rd rushing touchdown of the season, and Adrian Mora can tie this ball game up.
I was delayed on that one.
Yeah, the way they handle the fumbles. The way they handle the fumbles.
Only one of the officials signaled touchdown. Kind of scared me.
I got a feeling there would have been about 20,000 plus go down there and start a fight. As the kick is up, the kick is good, and we're tied 14-14 with 5:33 to play. The Eagles open the third quarter, drive down the field on 16 plays, and tie this ball game up. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. You're listening to Georgia Southern Football.
Leases for 36 months, 12,000 miles per year with zero down on Camry and Prius, $4,400 down on Tundra. Tundra discount includes all rebates and discounts with approved credit through November 1st, 2010. See dealer for details.
No interest for 60 months. No money down. No payments till January. All at Franklin Toyota Scion in Statesboro. New 2011 Camrys, just $254 a month with no money down. Or no interest for 60 months and no payments till January. Zero for 60 on 2010 Priuses with no payments till January. Or just $256 a month with no money down. Plus, up to $5,500 off 2011 Tundras. Or just $399 a month. And get 2 years free maintenance on all new Toyotas. Franklin Toyota Scion's a proud sponsor of Southern's Homecoming, Saturday, November 6th at 2 o'clock. We'll have a new Tundra on site, and you can register to win a $50 gift certificate to the university store. So come see us. We'll save you money. Beside the new Holiday Inn or at franklintoyota.com. It's Franklin Toyota.
Team 14, our score here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. 5:33 to play here in the third quarter. Georgia Southern takes the opening third quarter kickoff. 16 plays, 76 yards. Takes 9 minutes, 27 seconds before Darion Robinson picks up his 3rd rushing touchdown of the season from the 3-yard line. And Charlie Edwards will kick it off here, right to left, back to the Mountaineers. Here's the approach and the kick. Kick is high but short. It'll be fielded by an up back at the 25-yard line. And making his way to about the 36, maybe the 37-yard line, as Eagles give up the field position here on the short kick into the wind, which has been blustery here today on a cool afternoon in November.
I actually thought with Charlie kicking off, they may try to do one of Ryan's favorite plays and just squib it on down there. Certainly was effective last time. Now it'll be interesting to see how App State responds, as they have 3 receivers, 4 receivers out on the field right now. It's not a bad strategy if I'm App State.
First down and 10 at the 37-yard line. Presley will bring out the Mountaineer offense for the first time here in the third quarter. Send trip receivers to the right. Coco Hillary in a slot. He'll come out throwing. Looking for Hillary in his hands and incomplete at the 50-yard line. Threw it just behind Hillary, who had to turn and come back on his left arm.
Thank God.
But it's incomplete. Sets up second down and 10. And Hillary has been an Eagle killer over the years.
He should have been an Eagle, too, by the way. But anyway, and he thankfully he botched that one, or the quarterback did on that one. He was wide open of the seam, and that would have been a very quick response by App State, which we all know they're very capable of.
The time of possession means very little to Appalachian State. Second down, 10 at the 37. Presley again out of the shotgun. Gives it off. Cadet, he's going nowhere. Gets across the 35 to about the 37-yard line before Derek Hyden spins him up and down.
Well, that's a zone read, and that was a run blitz out of Georgia Southern. And needless to say, they read that backward.
Almost offsides, too, Ryan. We came in there on a blitz, the far side, and I thought we were going to be offsides. Third and nine.
Mountaineers on the day. 4 of 7 on third down conversions. They've had some big ones, and better watch out for the quarterback draw as Presley steps back in the shotgun. Again, trip receivers to the near side, and yes, it is a draw. And Presley off to the races, breaks a tackle, gets hit at the 41, and brought down shy of the first down at the 43-yard line. It'll be fourth down as Josh Rowe laid the final hit. They were looking for the draw, and the defense was ready. And the Mountaineers must punt it away.
Big, big stop for the Eagles. A very big stop after Presley was able to break that initial blitz and get through. It was a little bit open, and we closed quickly. Robinson staying on his own 15. A good return by here would be good as the wind is at the punter's back.
Sam Martin will stand at the 27. He'll take the snap, kick it away. Gets a nice kick, middle of the field. Robinson fields it. At about the 11, trying to come near side, then back to the middle of the field. He'll be dropped at about the 14-yard line. 3:58 to play, third quarter. 14-14, we're all tied. Georgia Southern, great defensive stand, great offensive stand to start the third quarter. We'll take back the football. First and 10 at their very own 14.
And thankfully, they made mistakes in that series, in particular that opening play. Coco Hillary not able to hold on to it. Well, actually, a poorly thrown pass set us up nicely. Good combination of Pry thrown in the blitz packages, as Ryan mentioned, and good run defense by Hyden.
Georgia Southern last week under 200 yards total offense on the Toyota Game Tracker. 221 yards for the Eagles so far today, 178 for the Mountaineers. First and 10 at the 14. Shaw under center, motions Wilcox right to left. He'll give it off to Robert Brown, who's tripped up at the line, falling forward across the 15. They'll mark him down at the 16-yard line, a pickup of 2. Second down and 8. Bobby Bonzo, the senior, able to trip up Robert Brown, the true freshman out of Macon, Georgia.
You know, we've been running, and we had success in that 16-play drive by running away from Bozzo, and I can understand why.
Third down and 8 at the 16. Wilcox again in a slot, far side. Trey Butler, lone receiver to the left side. On second down, Shaw comes out firing, deflected at the line and incomplete. Looked like Jabari Fletcher got his big paw up there, 6'3", 265. He'll knock it down, set up third down and 8. At the 16-yard line of the Eagles.
Pretty easy read by Jabari on that one. Threw it into his big mitt.
In comes Patrick Barker with the play. He'll relay it to Shaw in the huddle. They'll break from the huddle. Looking at third down and 8. Eagles today, 7 of 13 on third down. Everybody short on the line of scrimmage. Shaw looking to throw. Stepping up in the pocket, fires this one far side, but off the mark and incomplete. Looking for Nico Hickey near side, and it's incomplete. Sets up fourth down and 8. And Charlie Edwards will come on to punt it away here with 3:16 to play in the third quarter, and a quick offensive drive there shut down by the Mountaineer defense.
Just led him way too much. Nico couldn't get it. He had the defender on his back, heading by one step. He just made the catch. It had been the first down. Charlie punting into the wind. The ball on his own 16-yard line.
Charlie will kick it away from the 5.
Beautiful.
Gets that beautiful kick high into the air. Cadet calling for fair catch. Fields it at the 34-yard line. And that's where the Mountaineers take over. 3:09 to play in the third quarter. Tied 14-14. Georgia Southern and Appalachian State. Cadet, by the way, was the backup quarterback last year. And if you do remember, had 11 carries, 131 yards, and less than a half of action in Boone with a touchdown in the 52-16 win. Appalachian State able to rack up 712 yards of offense, most ever given up by Georgia Southern. 52 points in that game, the most ever given up by Georgia Southern in an FCS game. But Cadet moving to the running back position along with Devin Moore this season after DeAndre Presley has done nothing but impress as quarterback. First down and 10 at the 34. They'll motion Hillary right to left. Give it off to Hillary on the reverse, and he's going about 2 yards. That's it. Across the 35 to the 37-yard line, Michael Butler, the junior out of Stone Mountain, Georgia, on the stop for the Eagles. 2:55 to play, third quarter, 14-14. They'll give him about 4 yards.
Wow.
Actually, about 3 yards. It'll set up second down and 7.
Good job of stringing that out. By the way, great punt by Charlie Edwards, y'all. That was a 50-yard punt into this win. Beautiful punt.
Second down 7 at the 37-yard line of the Mountaineers. Two receivers right, one to the left. Presley out of a shotgun. One back on a wing to his right side. Quick fire in the flat near side. Catch is going to be made. B.J. Frazier made it to the 42, and that's it. Drop back after that. Short of the first down, but it will set up third and manageable here. About third and 2 upcoming for the Mountaineer offense.
Good play by Butler on that after the catch. Played behind the receiver, but Michael Butler, the junior out of Stone Mountain, made a great play.
Third down and 2 at the 42. Georgia Southern jump. May they have been pulled off, but right now they're going to let them play as they bring it to the near side. Cadet, or rather Presley, out of bounds. Flags came out all over the field. Looked like we jumped. Don't know if we were pulled.
Now, see, that's the way the quarterback is supposed to do it when he thinks the defense jumped off, not take a knee like the guy from Chattanooga did. That's the way you're supposed to play it, and I hope nobody flips
offside.
Him out for that.
Defense, number 94, 5-yard penalty, results in a first down.
Well, Roger Tinsley is called for the quick jump. And of course, there's been many a play this year where he's able to time it perfectly. That time just a little too antsy. And the 5-yard penalty will give the Mountaineers the first down, first and 10, just beyond their very own 48-yard line. As Brian Quick will check back into the game.
He scares me. Big kid, great wide receiver.
He'll line up wide to the right, short side of the field. They'll send two receivers to the left. Presley out of a shotgun. One back on a wing to his right side, and Devin Moore. Snap is back. Deep. Pressure coming. Presley rolling for his life. Sends was this one up to the air and incomplete near side and out of bounds at the 18-yard line. Looking for Brian Quick, but Derek Hyden, the only man able to make a play on it. But it's too wide, and it'll set up second down at 10 at the 48 of the Mountaineers.
Great play. Great pressure. Coach Munkin not very happy talking to the officials. Felt like there should have been a flag on that one. He thought maybe Quick held one of the guys who was trying to make the INT off of it. Not very happy camper about that one. But talking good defense.
Talking to the field judge here nearby and making his thoughts be known. Second and 10 at the 48. Two wide to the left. Quick again. Lone receiver. Short side of the field to the right. This time they'll move Moore on the left side. They'll set up option. Here's the late pitch. Moore's got it deep in the backfield, trying to turn it upfield. Far side. Flag coming out late as he's brought out of bounds by Michael Butler near the midfield stripe.
I believe that one's a hold, gentlemen.
Great play. We came up and took Presley on strong. Butler coming up. I like the way this kid's playing. Yeah. Butler right now.
Yeah, both he and Westbrooks are solid. Butler's just a solid, solid player. He kind of came out of nowhere in a lot of ways.
Shot block. Call. Looks like he's going to go against that wideout they have out that way. Must have come down and take out a knee.
You know, if you're Coach Pry, you got to feel good right now. You start to get a feeling the last two drives that App's starting to call plays, trying to go around the Georgia Southern defense.
Illegal block. Offense, number 85. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat, second down.
Rather than come out and try to establish that zone running game early, it seems like they're trying to play to the weakness of Georgia Southern or try to kind of match what Georgia Southern's showing defensively. If you're Coach Pry, you become the aggressor, and that's the spot you want to be in against this Appalachian State offense.
Second down and a cab right here, 23 yards after the infraction. Now back at the 34-yard line of Appalachian State. Again, trip receivers right, and the lone receiver to the left side, Presley shotgun snap. He'll come up. Flag comes out. Throws short side, far side at the 40. Brought down immediately is Brian Quick. And looks like another holding call will be upcoming for Appalachian State as that hanky hangs in the Mountaineer backfield.
They could have gotten two of those.
Yeah, exactly, because on our side, it looked like
Russell.
Yeah, and Josh Gephardt. So on one side, you had Russell being held. On the other side, you had Gephardt. And Mr. Russell's letting the officials know it was deed held on him.
Holding. Offense, number 62. That's a 10-yard penalty.
And Chris?
Repeat, second down.
You mentioned several times the defense had to get a score. If they continue pushing this back and hold at this point, that's just as good of a score to set up your offense in much better field position when the quarter flips in the fourth.
We're under a minute to play here in the third quarter, all tied 14-14, and Mountaineers just keep moving back. And this one is a long way away. Second down and 33. Ball placed at the 25-yard line of the Mountaineers. Trip receivers right, one to the left. Give it off to Cadet. He's got room left side and eventually brought down as he crosses the 35 to the 37-yard line. Josh Rowe laid a hit. He and Cadet collide well shy of the first down, but it sets up third and still a cab drive.
But what a great play call. You had three wide outs on their side, on their side. You had one wide Quick out on the other side. And keep in mind, Quick is matched up against against our freshman, Lavelle Westbrook, over there. He's 6'5". Westbrook's is 5'11". That's not a bad matchup if you're App State.
Pickup of about 10, 12 yards. It'll set up third and 21. And that's the end of the third quarter as the fans here at Homecoming 2010 trying to get on their feet and make some noise here as we head to the final 15 minutes of today's game. Tied 14-14. We'll return to Alan E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
What do you look for in a teammate? Speed? Power? Dependability? Then it's time you looked at joining Team Tundra. Lease a new 2011 Toyota Tundra Double Cab for $289 a month for 36 months with $3,288 due at signing for qualified lessees.
Cannot combine with other offers. Must complete sale and delivery between November 2nd and November 30th, 2010.
Join the team at your local Toyota dealer. Toyota, moving forward.
Real men of genius. Today we salute you, Mr. Stadium Scoreboard Marriage Proposal Guy. Your first proposal, her hand in marriage. Your second proposal, two more jumbo chili dogs.
Chili cheese!
It's the perfect plan, unless her name is spelled wrong. She's in the bathroom, or she says no.
Pretty please!
So crack open an ice cold Bud Light, Mr. Bachelor, on the big screen.
Mr. Stadium Scoreboard Marriage Proposal
Guy. Bud Light beer, Anheuser-Busch, St. Louis, Missouri.
Start of the fourth quarter here in Alan E. Paulson Stadium, all tied 14 apiece. Appalachian State and Georgia Southern. Let's pause 10 seconds so great stations like B100, WOBB in Columbus, and Easy 1230, WEZO in Augusta can identify themselves on the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
The flagship for Eagle Nation. Eagle 102.9, WPMX Statesboro, a Georgia Eagle broadcasting station.
14-14 our score, third down and 20 at the 38-yard line of their very own Appalachian State, trying to pull out the big third down play. They'll set up the screen. Here's Cadet. He's to the 40. He's to the 50 and brought down at the 46-yard line, 4 yards shy of the first down by Josh Rowe, but a good play, and they got a lot of yards on it. We'll see what Coach Jerry Moore decides to do, if he'll roll the dice here. In a tie ball game with 14:40 to play, it looks like he'll send out Sam Martin to punt this away.
Again, another great play call by App State. They didn't pick up the first down, but they ate up a lot of yards to get back in there. And if you're playing for field position, you got a good job on this one.
Three up backs in front of Sam Martin, who stands at the 40. Martin will kick it away high into the air. End over end. Robinson in traffic will call for the fair catch and have to dive to a knee to pull it down at the 18-yard line. That's where Georgia Southern takes over. 14-12 to play here in this fourth quarter of action. 2010 homecoming day. Georgia Southern taking on the Mountaineers of Appalachian State in the 26th meeting between these two schools. Appalachian State winning four out of the last five. have won two straight here at Paulson Stadium.
We have come awful close to that punter, Chris. Brent Russell doing a good job just driving the upbacks into the punter.
Georgia Southern on the field offensively, first down and 10 at their very own 18-yard line. Shaw under center, Robert Brown, your fullback. They'll send Robinson in motion. Shaw, option, left side, gets it off to Robinson, and he is buried for a loss as Mark Legree comes up and lays a hit. Back and around the 16-yard line, a loss of two. They'll say just 1 yard loss, and that's being kind.
Certainly was. It was a very well-defended play by Al, because not only did Shaw have nothing to keep it with, but that could have been extremely ugly for the Eagles.
Second down, 11 at the 17-yard line. Shaw stepping back, looking to throw. Fires this. Catch going to be made. It'll be by Williford up across the 25. Headed forward to just shy of the 26-yard line.
It's good to see his coaching staff putting Shaw on a straight drop. What that tells me is that the blocking and pass protection is good enough where they have some confidence. They're not just sprinting them out. They've had a couple of drop back straight drops from Shaw under center today.
I like that. 7 of 13 on third down conversions on the day, I believe.
Third down, 3, just beyond the 25-yard line of their very own. Everybody in the box for the Mountaineers. Option, far side, pitch, Robinson. He's got the first down across the 30. Stopped at the 31. Dominique McDuffie made the stop, but first down and 10, Georgia Southern with 12:53 to play here in this ballgame. Today's homecoming attendance, 20,073, came through the gates to see number one Appalachian State and Georgia Southern.
Fifth annual Blue Owl, number one team in the nation, the old nemesis App State in town. Great homecoming events going on. Good to see everybody back.
First down and 10 now at the 30-yard line. Just the nose of the football beyond the 30. Working from the left hash mark. Shaw. Toss. Give it off to Robinson. Trying to make his way to the 34-yard line. Far sideline. Just stopped shy of the 4. 3.5-yard pickup. They'll say second down. A short 7 upcoming.
This amazes me because it looks like it's a no-gainer. And then he gets up off the pile and he's picked up 3 or 4 yards.
Patrick Barker back into the game. Relays the play. Brent Davis up here in the box. Down to Coach Munkin on the sideline. Second down, 6 at the 34. 12:01 to play in this game. Everybody short on the line of scrimmage. Receivers very tight, both left and right. Giving off Robert Brown, and he's hit immediately right at the handoff. Drop at the 35-yard line. Chris Aiken, junior out of Austin, Texas, on the stop. Set up third down and about 6 yards.
Wow.
Got to get just beyond the 40-yard line for a first down. As back into the game comes Mitch Williford. He'll relay the call in.
Wouldn't be surprised to see Shaw keep this on a draw. It'd be a bad play.
Eagles on the afternoon, 8 of 15 on third down. Third and 5 from the 35-yard line. Two receivers right, one to the left. Jay Beauchamp takes the snap. Option, pitches it. Robert Brown in no man's land barely gets back to the line of scrimmage before being stopped by Dan Wiley. That time, Appalachian State called it up, dialed it up perfectly. They knew they were coming to the near side of the field. And that'll set up 4th and 5.
We're thinking about it. We're thinking about it here on 4th and 5. We are going to send the punting unit out, but if you noticed on that play, Robinson going against it almost like it was going to be a reverse and Brown keeping it. That may set up the play for later on as Charlie comes out to punt, standing on his own 20 with the wind at his back.
Cadet will be back to receive inside the 25-yard line of the Mountaineers. 10.5 minutes, low snap, but Charlie gets it away, and it's another boomer. This one high in the air, but Cadet may be able to field this one. He drops it at the 15, picks it back up, and knocked out of bounds at the 22-yard line by E.J. Webb down on special teams. So first down and 10 at the 21 for the Mountaineers, 10:20 to play. And a tie game, 14-14. Fans, Paulson Stadium takes an entire team to keep it in its beautiful condition. Get your own team to beautify your home's yard with Olive Branch Landscaping. If you're looking for a design team to turn your property into a paradise, look no further for commercial and residential Olive Branch Landscaping. Online at olivebranchlandscape.com or call them at 489-2500. First down and 10 at the 21. Presley empties the backfield. Preston takes the snap.
Going! And he's going nowhere. Dropped at the 16-yard line. Josh Rowe got to him. As it looked like they were setting it up for Presley to try to go right side. And I don't know if anybody touched anybody from the offensive line of Appalachian State. Everybody came crashing in.
Yeah, they certainly did, Ryan.
Yeah, one-on-one with Tinsley, and he holds that up. And then Rowe and Westbrook's coming off the corner. Double team him up high.
Second down, 15. Mark it at the just shy of the 16-yard line of the Mountaineers. This time, trip receivers left, one lone to the right. Presley, shotgun snap, fires, and caught. Hillary's got it. Made the catch at the 38, falls forward to the 41-yard line, first down and 10, and Hillary comes up with some big catches when you need it.
The defense came up with a big play for App State on that one. We were in position to make the play. Josh Rowe was thinking about jumping up to knock it down. I thought he was in position. We had three guys in position, Ryan.
I thought he was in the line of the pass. If he steps up and tries to take that, that's pick six going the other way.
Darius Eubanks hobbled off to the near sideline. The outside linebacker for the Eagles, first down and 10 at the 43. Hillary in motion. They'll fake the give to him. Presley steps back, throwing for the home run ball down the field. Catch is bobbled and caught. Down around the 15-yard line by Brian Quick. Had it in the hands, dropped it, and then on his way down, holds on for the big-time catch. And it'll be first down and 10 for the Mountaineers at the Eagle 15.
That was a catch, ladies and gentlemen. That's called concentration. He stayed with it. Burned our guy. We played the receiver, not the ball, but Quick stayed with it. What an amazing catch.
Mountaineers ready to roll with 9:12 to play in this game. First down and 10. The ball placed at the 16 of the Eagles. Two receivers right, one to the left side. Presley shotgun snap. He'll roll to his left. Now cut it upfield and try to get back to the line of scrimmage near the 15 before Brent Russell puts him down on the dirt. Pickup of a yard. It'll be second down and 9. Great catch by Brian Quick.
My goodness alive. I mean, that was just amazing. Just amazing.
Junior out of Columbia, South Carolina, comes into the game with 5 touchdowns on the season.
He's got an arm, does Presley. He reminds you of another guy they had in the shotgun. I would say under center, but they never went under center.
I hope that guy only comes around once.
Second down 9. At the 16-yard line of the Eagles, Presley out of a shotgun. Gives it to Cadet. Tries to go right and then cuts it back left to the middle of the field. Down to the 14-yard line. Pickup of 2. E.J. Webb made the stop. Set up 3rd down and 7 here for the Mountaineers. Inside the Eagle red zone with 8:06 to play in a tie game, 14-all.
Good play by E.J. Webb. But again, you got to make the play against App State. You can't let them get on you, and that's what we did by allowing them to get down here. It opened up the big long play for Quick. Should have knocked that ball down against Coco.
Darius Eubanks checking back in as outside linebacker. Jerry Moore will call a timeout. 7:48 to play, 3rd down and 7 at the Eagle 14-yard line. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
For over 50 years, Bowler Family Practice has specialized in total health care for your entire family. Located at 128 North Parker Avenue in downtown Brooklyn, Bowler Family Practice treats your entire family from childhood to adults, baby checkups, immunizations, athletic and DOT physicals, lab services, x-rays, EKGs, geriatric help, hearing and vision screenings, pulmonary function testing, women's health care, and pap smears, just to mention a few of the services Bowler Family Practice offers. As you can see, Bowler Family Practice can treat your entire family regardless of health needs and ages. All your family health needs in one location in Bowler County. Open Monday, Tuesday, Fridays, 9 a.m. to 6 p.m., Wednesdays and Saturdays from 9 a.m. to noon. Appointments are appreciated, but walk-ins are welcome. So if you're looking for health care for the entire family at one location, call or stop by Bowler Family Practice in Brooklyn or call 842-2101. Take the step. Keep your family healthy with the help of Bowler Family Practice.
After the Appalachian State timeout, looking at 3rd down and 7 at the Eagle 14-yard line, tied up 14-14 here, Appalachian State and Georgia Southern at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Some big 3rd down conversions so far in this game for the Mountaineers and Coach Jerry Moore.
Westbrook lined up on Coco Hillary. You got Eubanks lined up over there on B.J. Frazier and LaRon Scott on Quick.
Two receivers left, one to the right side. They show blitz. App handles it.
Throws, picked off at the 1 yard line. Eagles coming the other way. It'll be Michael Butler tripped up at the 22 yard line. Oh my, credit Derek Hyden. Brought the pressure and forced the throw from Presley probably too soon. And Michael Butler steps right in, makes the interception. The junior out of Stone Mountain, Georgia, with his first INT of the season. And with 7:38 to play, Georgia Southern turns back the Mountaineers of Appalachian State.
And you hit it right on the nose. The blitz called by Pry, Hyden getting in there right in Presley, forced him to throw it too quickly, and Ryan Butler just kind of snuck in there.
I'm going to tell you something. Coach Pry and this defensive staff absolutely love that kid. They talk so high of him. He's got a bright future. What a play.
Well, the defense have not scored points today, but they've given the offense a chance here with 7:38 to play in this game. First down and 10 at the 23. Shaw fakes the reverse. He'll throw near side. Wilcox has got it at the 35. He's hemmed in and finally brought down back at the 30. Let's see where they give him forward motion. I think they're going to save the 32-yard line, but he caught it at the 35. Troy Sanders made the stop.
And Munkin's politicking the line judge because he doesn't like where they spotted it.
The ball was caught at the 35.
But he was thinking it was a first down. That's why he was pushing for the first down marker over here. Now, I got to tell you about that play that I like so much. He was actually wanting Sumner down the hash mark. He saw that Sumner was well covered and checked off to Wilcox.
Well, they're going to now get a chain crew to come over from the far side to take a look at it here. It appeared the spot was going to be short, although would have set up second down and short here, but they're going to go ahead and bring the chains and set it down and see how close it is. Coach Munkin lobbying, as Terry said, for the spot, and it's just shy.
You know,
about
watching
6 inches shy.
Watching the Butler interception, boys, if he high steps one more tackle, yeah, he finds the far sidelines, that may go 99 the other way.
Jay Beauchamp hobbling over to the near side.
Hobbling.
He is
about right.
He is gutting it out, the junior from Flowery Branch, as he comes to talk to Coach Munkin near side. He'll head back to the huddle here with 7:11 to play, tied 14-14. And the ball placed just shy of the 33-yard line. It'll be second down and less than a yard here for the Eagles offense. Tyler Sumner will line up wide out to the right side. They'll send Trey Butler out to the left. Robert Brown, Darion Robinson, and J.J. Wilcox in the offensive backfield. Behind Jay Beauchamp, second and less than a yard at the 33. Motion Robinson. Fake the quick toss again. Throwing near side and just couldn't get it on the mark. Wilcox open at midfield. That time, App State's D.J. Smith had to come out of the middle linebacker position to give coverage, and he was lost, and Wilcox was wide open near side, and they'll go for third and short, but a good play call there, just couldn't execute.
He had two receivers open. He had Wilcox over there, and he had Sumner on the post route. He actually looked at Sumner and thought twice about it and went back to Wilcox. Sumner was there.
So now third and less than a yard at the 33. Under 7 minutes to play, 6 minutes and 57 seconds. Clock stopped after the incompletion. Shaw will keep it left tackle. He's got the first down up across the 45 to the 46, or rather 36-yard line. First down and 10, Georgia Southern move the chains with 6:53 to play. Remember, fans, tune in each week for Inside the Huddle during each Citizens Bank tailgate show to get to know your Eagles better. Inside the Huddle presented by Copper Beach Townhome Communities, because size matters. Learn more about Statesboro's best townhome living by logging on to cbeach.com. That's cbeech.com. First down and 10. Ball at the 38-yard line. Middle of the field. Shaw under center. Taking out option near side. Late pitch. Gives it off Wilcox. Near sideline. 45. Dives his way to midfield. First down and 10, Georgia Southern.
Late pitch to Wilcox, but great blocking by Robinson on that play. Took his defender and took him out of bounds, and that's what opened that play, Ryan.
And the pitch, we talked about it, Terry, the second quarter. But dating back to Elon, it was that dive over and over on first down, setting up second and five. Then the pitch started coming on first down.
Take a 16-play drive for 6 minutes here.
First down and 10 at the 49-yard line of the Mountaineers. Working from the right hash, attacking left to right. Shaw giving it off. Robert Brown protecting the football and making his way just shy of the 46 of the Mountaineers. Pickup of maybe 3 yards. They'll say just 2.5. That'll set up second down and 8.
You know, part of my job as a sideline reporter is the game day experience, and I know fans listening at home would be interested to hear that one tradition brought back today was Southern Pride playing of Doctor Who here in the second half.
That's what they were spelling at halftime. I was trying to figure that out.
It's just WHO. That's all.
Well, you got to pass English.
Just a couple of letters. Second down 8 at the 47. Shaw. Caught after the snap. Nobody touched Dan Wiley. He comes up and brings down Shaw, trying to set the option up near side.
The Brandavious man had nothing for him. He was trying to, like, get him in the back. He couldn't do anything for him. That's we always talk about, how do you defend the triple option or the spread option? Penetration. Third down and 9. Southern having success. If there is a third down conversion, that's crucial. Might be the most important one of the ball game, folks.
Eagles on the afternoon, 9 of 17, staring down third and 9 at the 48 of the Mountaineers with 4:53 to play in this game. Two receivers left, one to the right. Shaw taking out, steps up in the pocket, fires this one deep down the field for Wilcox, and he had it and dropped it at the 12. Oh, that time. Dominique McDuffie mistimed his jump, went over his hands, and Wilcox had it in the chest and dropped it at the 12-yard line. Otherwise, that's a first down. And if he holds on and stays on his feet, that's a score. And that'll bring out Charlie Edwards here with 4:39 to play.
Oh, folks, that was in his hands. My goodness, all the circus catches we've seen Wilcox make.
Oh, you got to feel for him. He is the sickest man on that sideline.
Edwards will come out to punt. Punt it into the air, high, hangs up. Cadet calling for the fair catch. He'll field it at the 8-yard line. 4:31 to play, 14-14. We're in a tie ball game. And Appalachian State now has the football, first down and 10. The market between the 13 and 14, that's where they'll take over.
Man, what you didn't want to do is give this quick strike offense the ball to win the game on a touchdown or field goal with a good leg, the field goal kicker. You're asking your defense to do it somehow, find a way to stop them.
How,
just one more time.
How timid is Presley going to be to throw the ball here, though?
Not at all. I don't think so. Not these guys.
First down and 10 at the 13. They'll send two receivers out to the left. Presley will stick the tight end and give it off to Cadet right up the middle. He'll cross the 15 up to about the 16-yard line. Pickup of 3. Deion DeBose made the stop with 4:22. Clock continuing to move here in the fourth quarter of action, tied 14-14.
Picks up 4 yards on the play, brings the ball to about the 17-yard line. 4 minutes and counting left to go in this ball game.
Defense here with a chance to make a play. Second down and 6 at the 17. Presley looking to throw. Fires near side and incomplete at the 20, looking for Frazier, and he takes a hit. From who else but Michael Butler?
That's a senior play. That's an absolute senior play. Every freshman I've ever seen is going to go for the ball there, and there's a chance that receiver takes it right down the sideline. Butler at no point looked like he cared anything about going after that ball. He was going headhunt, and he got it.
He timed it out perfectly, and huge, huge third down conversion. Look for Blake Elder in this play. Look for Blake Elder. They like him here.
4 of 10 on third down, 3rd and 6 at the 17. I still say you look for Presley on the draw. We'll see. Out of the shotgun, blitz coming. Presley wanting to throw at the sticks. Catch is made far side at the 23-yard line. This time Frazier goes from near side to far side, makes the catch, and gives the Appalachian State Mountaineers a first down with 3:48, gets out of bounds. They'll start the clock once they get everything set after the first down change.
And he delivered that money. Stayed in the pocket, just delivered on the money. And they match up quick over there against Westbrook again. The freshman, Westbrook, has his hands full.
3 receivers near side, 1 to the long. 3:33, clock moving. First down and 10 at the 25. Off to Cadet, right up the middle. Across the 25 to the 26-yard line. Only about a yard gain. Looks like the spot's going to be a 1-yard gain. Second down and 9 with 3:19, clock moving here in the fourth quarter.
Tinsley Roderick stuffs the middle. Or Roger Tinsley, whatever you want to say.
Second down 9. Mountaineers ready to roll. Send out 3 receivers to the left. 1 to the lone side. Trying to communicate here with the offensive line. The receivers helping out.
Crowd getting loud. That's what we need.
Cadet on a wing to the right side of Presley. Shotgun snap. Pressure comes. Hit as he throws. Lost this one into the air. And it is broken up. Westbrook's had a chance to make the INT. Looking for Brian Quick. No flags on the play. And Presley took a beating when he released that ball. It will set up third down. And a short nine here for the Mountaineer offense.
Oh, Westbrook wants that one back too. Wow. Need to turn it up a notch, True Blue out there. Big third down conversion here, big.
If I am Georgia Southern, I am putting somebody near the first down sticks. Without a draw from Presley, they're going to throw to the sticks. They've only got 2:49 to go in this game. They need 9 yards. They'll send a couple deep with this trip formation to the left and a couple to the first down sticks. And there it is. Quick's got it. First down at the 37-yard line.
And he took a hit, and so did our guy took a hit. We're getting up off slow off the ground on that one. Maybe Butler as well. Get back up with Eubanks. Mr. Eubanks takes a hit. But again, they dial it up and they make the play. They know where they need to be, and he delivered, Chris.
Great call. They had the trip receivers headed downfield. They brought Quick up. He came across the middle right at the first down sticks and hit him on the numbers as Eubanks on his own power coming off to the near side with help from the training crew. And again, as we mentioned, Brian Quick a little slow to get up as that collision took place at the 37-yard line. They'll mark it at the 38. First down and 10 for the Mountaineers. 2:43 to play in this game. Tied 14-14 here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
2:43 left to go in this ball game. Obviously, they'd like a touchdown, but they would take three. No doubt in my mind if I'm them. Long field goal is 39 yards. There we go.
First down and 10 at the 38-yard line.
Give me a turnover.
Snap back to Presley. Option coming near side. Flag coming out as he'll cut it up the middle and dive down near the line of scrimmage. Roderick Tinsley brought him down. We'll see what the penalty is all about. Wait and see as Ed Rhodes.
Ooh, there's no foul.
Waves
it
off.
No foul.
Second down.
Huh. All right.
So Zach off the it's coming back on.
Second down 10 at the 38. They'll say maybe a half yard loss. Looks more like second and 11 here with 2:10 to play. Trip receivers again to the left. One long receiver to the right. Presley out of the shotgun. Stepping back, firing this one far side and overthrown. Nowhere close. Down around the 40-yard line.
Yeah, what happened on that play? Particularly had a running back coming out of the backfield there. Travaris Cadet coming out. It was supposed to be a wheel route. Hyden did a good job, covered him in the flat. Presley had, because of the pressure, had to release it too soon. Brings up another third down.
1:56 to play in this game. 14-14 our score. Third down and a little more than 10 for the Mountaineers at the 38-yard line. They've gotten the big third down conversions today when they've needed it. Only 50%, 6 of 12 on the afternoon. Trip receivers again to the left, one lone receiver to the right. Presley going to tuck it and run. Presley in trouble now, will drop it off. Incomplete at the 48-yard line. Fourth down and 10 at the 38-yard line. I don't think the clock moved at all.
Just a little bit, you're right. But great presence of mind by Presley, Ryan, to know where he was on the field. Looked like he was going to tuck it up and run, and he knew he wasn't at the line. He didn't pass the line of scrimmage, so he threw it.
You're in a tough spot. Is he going to keep or is he going to toss? And everyone kind of sat and waited there and just...
I guarantee I know what Armani Edwards would have done.
Yeah, oh, we know what Armani would have done.
He would have tucked and run.
Block it. You don't hit the punter.
Martin gets it away. Had pressure. Near side kick. Takes a Georgia Southern bounce at the 25, but couldn't move by the Mountaineers to down it at the 25-yard line. And with 1:41 to play, Georgia Southern has the football. It's a tie game, 14-all.
A classic. Another classic Georgia Southern Appalachian State ball game. My goodness. Great pressure on the punter as well. Thought we were going to get one there. We've come awful close today. Now we're just, 75 yards away.
and the wind has shifted on us.
First down at 10 at the 25. Shaw under center. Takes out, fakes the option. Pressure coming, trying to stay on his feet, and he'll be dropped.
He was there.
At the 22-yard line, Dan Wiley brought him down.
Wilcox was there. Butler was there. Wilcox was there. Wide open. We missed him. Couldn't get to him.
Loss of 3 yards. It'll set up second down and 13. Back at the 22-yard line, clock moving, a minute 15. Eagles look a little out of sorts there coming out of the huddle. Eventually, Mitch Williford comes to the near sideline. Now they'll break the huddle.
Get me a field goal range. Come on now.
Approaching the 1 minute mark. 1 minute, 2 seconds. Now we're at the 1 minute mark. Shaw takes a snap. Rolling out. And again, nowhere to go. Pressure. He's dropped at the 13-yard line again by Dan Wiley. And the Eagles doing nothing but moving backward here with 52.9 seconds.
And I believe App State, if they're not calling a timeout, they ought to be in this scenario. And they are.
Timeout taken by the Mountaineers. 52.9 seconds remain. Georgia Southern with a football, but third down and forever upcoming. Tied 14-14. We'll return. This is Georgia Southern football.
He's really cute.
He just reheated our calamari.
Women love that goat. Now, how does he breathe fire?
That's Kevin. He ate my Keno ticket after I played the hot numbers.
Oh, right, hot numbers.
Kevin's goat girlfriend just walked in.
Run, Kevin! It's all fun and games till the girlfriend shows up.
Play Keno from the Georgia Lottery for a chance to win up to 100 grand every 4 minutes. Today could be the day. Please play responsibly.
Keno!
Hello, everybody. This is Chris Blair, and nobody shows more pride than Georgia Southern fans. And the University Store can help you show your true blue every day at work or at play. With exclusive Nike sideline gear, Under Armour, and Russell Athletic apparel, make it clear that you bleed Georgia Southern blue. You can shop their campus location, their game day locations at Paulson Stadium, or online anytime at gsustore.com. Helping you be true blue every day. Show your Eagle pride with a visit to the University Store. More than just a bookstore. The official outfitter to the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Third down and 20 for the Eagles offense here with just 52.9 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter, tied 14-14. Fourth quarter action at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. And Georgia Southern slugging it out with the number one team in the land. But staring down third and 20 here, two plays, trying to throw downfield. Nowhere to go as Shaw under center again. Will take out. It's a draw. Shaw coming near side. He's to the 20. Needs a couple of blockers as he makes it to the 32-yard line. Out of bounds near side. Didn't get the first down.
Stay in bounds.
And with 40 seconds.
No, he did stay in bounds.
He did stay in bounds. Brought it down at the 31.
Not bad for field position here because you got to punt the ball. You can't go for it here.
Timeout taken to stop the clock with 33 seconds. We'll take one with him. We'll return 14-14. Georgia Southern staring down a fourth down and three when we return. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
Did you know that Southern Billiards and Burgers has the best pool tables, the tastiest burgers, and the lowest drink prices in the borough? On Wednesdays, it's poker and pitchers with $6 pitchers with free entry into poker tournaments. Thursday night, it's beer and billiards with $1.50 domestic drafts and $2.50 import drafts with a game of pool. And Friday, half-price jumbo wings and all appetizers till 6 p.m. Southern Billiards and Burgers across from the stadium in Statesboro. Want to put the boat in the water but think it's just too much trouble? Not feeling like dealing with all the work that gets in the way of a pleasurable boating experience? Not if you leave it all up to Hogan's Marina. Hogan's Marina has everything you need. A dry rack, wet storage, and launching facility. And while you're there, make sure you check out their marine store with live bait and fishing tackle, restrooms, and refreshments. Call them at 912-897-FISH. Hogan's Marina, making boating better since 1991. Located at 36 Wilmington Island Road, next to Publix in Savannah.
On fourth down and three, the Eagles will kick it away here late in the fourth quarter. Fair catch called for at the 31. And Cadet hauls it in with 26 seconds remaining. Jason Viteris on the season has a long of 39 yards. They'll take this over first down and 10 at the very own 31-yard line. You got to feel like you got to get inside at least the 35 to have a chance.
What a great play by Butler as Cadet waited to the very last second to wave a fair catch because Butler is about to drill him, and he was able to pull off on it. Very big play.
26 seconds remain in the fourth quarter here, tied 14-14. First down and 10 at the 31. Appalachian State, two receivers left, two to the right. Presley sets back in a shotgun. One back on a wing to his left. Moore is back there to pass block. Presley in trouble. Lost this one in the air and out of bounds far side as he's brought down as Roderick Tinsley came back with pressure. And Presley dropped it to 10 but got rid of the football with 18.9 seconds remaining in the game. Second down, 10 at the 31.
Wow, great pressure by Tinsley. Thought we had one there. Like to see him loft that ball up in the field of play. Big pick six would be a great way to end homecoming today.
You know you've got some confidence in a freshman or a quarterback really starting his first season, I should say, when you're letting him toss it around this deep.
Second down, 10 at the 31. 18.9 seconds remain in the game. Shotgun snap off to Moore. He'll go up the middle to the 35 to the 36 with 13 seconds.
I think they like their chances with overtime.
I believe they do. They'll let the final seconds roll off the clock. And for the first time this season, Georgia Southern and Appalachian State will head to overtime session here on Homecoming 2010. Four quarters come to an end. We're all tied 14-14. We'll return to Allen E. Paulson Stadium for free football this Saturday in just a moment. This is the Georgia Southern Radio Network.
I'm attending a university that I chose because of the national and international opportunities that it will provide. I'm a member of Greek Life, a SOAR leader, a Southern ambassador, and current president of the Student Government Association. I've had so many opportunities, like getting to meet Condoleezza Rice when she came to speak on campus, and my goal is to student teach in a foreign country next year. I'm Alton Stanford. I'm from Monticello, Georgia. I'm a senior at Georgia Southern University, and I'm Georgia Southern True Blue. Are you?
Visit Georgia Southern University today. Online at georgiasouthern.edu.
All right, football fans, let's hear what the scouts have to say about the 2011 Toyota Camry.
It's got agility. It's got agility out the wazoo.
It's a proven leader. You look at the records, the numbers, it'll make your head spin.
So get 0% APR financing for 60 months on a new 2011 Toyota Camry. And payments are deferred until 2011. Zero down with approved credit. Includes hybrids. Cannot combine with other offers. Must complete sale and delivery between November 2nd and November 30th, 2010. Toyota, moving forward.
Back at Allen E. Paulson Stadium this Saturday afternoon. A great game thus far in fourth quarters, 14-14. And we've got more football to play as they head to overtime here. They'll head to midfield, the toss of the coin, and decide who goes first. We'll go down to Ryan Chambers and referee Ed Rhodes.
You get the coin option. You're going to get a choice of offense, defense, or into the field. You cannot defer. All right? After that, we will simply switch ends. We have to go to a second overtime. The team that loses a toss will get their first option on the next overtime. We have any questions? Okay, again, same coin. Tails and a heads. Heads and a tails. What is your call? He has called a tails. If I drop it again, it is a tails. You've got it. You want offense, defense, or in the field? You'll play defense.
Appalachian State has got it. They will win the toss here at overtime. They will put Georgia Southern offense to start things out. 14-14, our score. And if memory serves, first overtime game ever between Georgia Southern and Appalachian State.
You know, that's a good question. I know it came down to the wire. We thought we had him, and Armani pulled out something. I don't know how to this day he did it. And Coco came down with the ball. I remember that one. But certainly been some classic finishes between these two schools. App State's come in here number one before, and Georgia Southern knocked them off. App State came in here a couple years back, and we came close, and that's when Armani pulled it out. I certainly like my chances in the ballgame versus overtime here. They have so many weapons, so many weapons. Eagle fans, you got to be proud of these boys where they played
especially spotting them 14 points in the opening two drives of the ball game, turned the ball over several times, and here you are knotted up at 14 in overtime, and a lot of the folks are still here on the hill wearing their blue, they're bundled up. Cold weather here today as we're going to be starting off on offense facing going towards Bishop Fieldhouse. So we'll be going away from the scoreboard towards Bishop Fieldhouse, and wind is just kind of a weird factor. At one time you could say, Chris, this was going into the wind. Now it's a more of a crosswind, if anything. Wait a minute. Are they shifting on us? They are. They're changing the sides. All right.
Appalachian State and Southern Conference play 5-2 in overtime, 71%. Georgia Southern 4-5 at 44%.
Everything I just said, take that back. Now they're going to be going towards the scoreboard.
Yeah.
You want to go
I
over
need the exercise anyway.
All right, Chris, you want to go over how the overtime start with the ball at the 25?
Start at the 25-yard line. Got to get in and score. Then the opposing team gets the chance once again in college football. It's not sudden death. So the Eagles will get a chance here to crack the scoreboard and break the stalemate 14-all in the first overtime session here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium for 2010. Georgia Southern will send out quarterback Jabo Shaw, fullback Robert Brown, J.J. Wilcox, Darion Robinson, your A-backs. Wilcox in motion will fake the toss to him. Shaw stands in the pocket, throws this one far side and over the head of Robinson, or rather Robert Brown, far side around the 5-yard line. Second down, 10 at the 25.
You take Brown, send him out. It's kind of a in the flats and then wheel it up the sideline, and he just, thankfully, he threw it where it couldn't be intercepted. But unfortunately, Brown couldn't get to it either.
Eagles will huddle up. Now break from the huddle as Mitch Williford brought in the play. He'll line up as a receiver right side. Tyler Sumner wide to the left. Check that. Patrick Barker wide to the left. Shaw, second down and 10. Option. He'll keep. Shaw makes his way to the 21 before being brought down by John Reiser. Pick up of 4 yards. It'll set up third down and 6 here in the overtime session.
Haven't seen more on the field today for next field goals. A crosswind, as we mentioned, going from the visitor's side to the home side today. Ball spotted at the 21.
Third down and 5, just shy of the 20-yard line here in overtime. Georgia Southern moving left to right on your dial. Two receivers left, one to the right. Now they'll motion Robinson from left to right. Shaw, option. Shaw will keep. Shaw's to the 15. Shaw breaks a shoestring tackle. He's to the 5. Brought down at the 4-yard line. First down and 10, Georgia Southern. What an improvised play by Jabo Shaw. I've called him Mr. Guts all afternoon. The 6-foot-201-pound junior out of Georgia Southern just brought that one down, and there's a Mountaineer down on the field at the 3-yard line.
Wow, what a great gutsy play by Shaw Ryan. Not only was it a good read, but he had the feeling of knowing where the lanes were for the cutback.
He's such a gamer. He's such a gamer. That's the hands you wanted in right there. He finds it, like you said, the cutback lane, and now you've marched him to the doorstep.
Mark LeGree, the Mountaineer down on the field, the senior safety out of Columbus, Georgia.
He has played an amazing game, too.
Oh, he's had some great games.
Wow.
For 4 years for the Mountaineers.
Pacelli High School in Columbus, which is where Nico Hickey is from, if I'm not mistaken. Pacelli.
Still taking a look at LeGree down at the 3-yard line.
You look at that App State team, and they've done a very solid job of recruiting, obviously, and they love the state of Georgia. Dan Wiley is from Washington Wilkes. You got Fletcher on the defensive line from Grady High School. Of course, we already mentioned LeGree. You got Justin Ray from Covington out of Eastside. That's just on their defensive side, and that's just their starters.
LeGree now was on his back. He's now leaned up, sitting up now as the trainers still take a look at him. Eagles looking at first down, goal to goal at the Mountaineer 4-yard line. We're in overtime here in a 14-14 game as now LeGree gets up. Whether John Reiser was the injured Mountaineer, I stand corrected. Reiser, the left defensive end, was slow to get up. Couldn't see the jersey. He's number 93. Thought it was 13, so My bad. My apologies to the Legree family and to the Reiser family.
Brett Moore checking on him as well, showing a little class there. Senior offensive lineman out of Warner Robins, Northside High School. All righty, stick it in.
First down, goal to go at the four. Brandavius Mann will break the huddle. He'll send Trey Butler out wide to the left side. Wilcox, Robinson, and Robert Brown behind J-Bo Shaw. Robinson in motion. Now Shaw will rise back up, get him reset. Snap. Robert Brown powering his way down. Put an Eagle 6 on it. Touchdown, Georgia Southern, 20-14. First time in overtime. Georgia Southern has the lead for the first time this afternoon as Robert Brown picks up his fourth touchdown of the season, the freshman out of Macon, Georgia. As Shaw made the right read, put it in the belly, and Brown takes it for the ride. More on for the all-important point after. Snap, Edwards with a set, kick on its way, kick is up and good. 21-14, Georgia Southern strikes first in overtime. Appalachian State will have it when we return. 21-14, Eagles lead, will return. This is Georgia Southern football.
Changing times have affected many banks, but there's something you should know. Queensborough National Bank and Trust has consistently grown and prospered for more than 100 years. Careful management and consideration of customers' needs is how Queensborough National Bank and Trust has become one of the highest-rated community banks in Georgia. Make the switch to better banking. Queensborough National Bank and Trust Company, with locations in Statesboro, Metter, Sylvania, and Millen.
The heart of your neighborhood, Queensborough National Bank and Trust.
Lovett Bennett Jr., attorney at law of PC, wishes the best to Coach Jeff Monken and the Georgia Southern Eagles. Lovett is a 78 graduate and proud supporter of Georgia Southern. If you should ever need legal representation for DUI or criminal defense or for driver's license issues, call on Lovett and his staff located on Cortland Street. And be sure to follow the Eagles each night on Upon Further Review on Cable Channel 96, 7 p.m., 9 p.m. in the evenings, and 7 a.m. in the mornings.
Went away for a break. Appalachian State got back to action, picked up 14 yards on the first carry, got down to the 11-yard line of the Eagles. They give it off to Moore a second time. He tries to bounce it out left side, gets down to about the 7-yard line before he's bounced out of bounds. 21-14, Georgia Southern leads here in overtime. Appalachian State with their first opportunity for free football.
LaRon Scott and E.J. Webb doing a good job of stringing him out and then bouncing him out of bounds. We have an injured player. It looks like the App State guys, we drilled him out of bounds. A clean hit, but again, LaRon Scott doing a good job, Ryan, of shedding the blocker and making the tackle.
It's assignment ball now. I mean, if you ever had to play assignment, you got a quarterback that can move the pocket. I mean, so many plays, so many of the big plays today have come after, you know, the play almost breaks down because Presley moves the pocket so well with his feet.
Second down and 6 at the Eagle 7-yard line. They can get a first down at the 1. They can get into the score.
Give me a turnover.
With 7 yards. Presley will send out one receiver right, one to the left. Second down, 6 at the Eagle 7. Presley now calling, shouting instructions. They'll move Cadet from the right side to the left side of Presley. Presley running, slips, and dropped at the 11-yard line. Roderick Tinsley forced him back. He wanted to go left. Tinsley came up, showed him his grill, and Presley falls down at the 11-yard line. It'll set up third down at the 11 and 10 yards for a first down, 11 for a score. Down 21-14, Georgia Southern with their first lead of the afternoon comes in overtime against the number one team in the country.
Again, so many weapons. Presley can run with it. He can lob it up to Quick in the end zone. We've seen that happen to us before.
Crowd gets on their feet here at Allen E. Paulson Stadium. Third down and 10 at the 11-yard line. Presley out of the shotgun. Presley in the pocket now. Decides to tuck and run. Presley in trouble and dropped at the 9. Ball loose. Georgia Southern's got it. Number one goes down. Georgia Southern has defeated Appalachian State 21-14 in overtime at Allen E. Paulson Stadium.
Here comes the fans. There's going to be a celebration at Statesboro tonight.
Holy cow. 14, the final score at Alan E. Paulson Stadium. Georgia Southern just beat number one Appalachian State for the first time in three seasons. Congratulations to head coach Jeff Monken and the Georgia Southern Eagles as the black and gold go back black and blue to Boone today. Georgia Southern with a win, 21-14. More to come as we celebrate this Saturday afternoon for Homecoming 2010. I'll say it again and say it loud. Georgia Southern 21, Appalachian State 14. This is Georgia Southern football.